Hello? Microphone? There you go, Jesus. Right, let me just... I'm a professional, let me just adjust my chair. Adjust my cables, they're all over the place. This music is very loud, let me turn that down as well. There we go. Right then! Yeah, sorry guys, yeah. You know, just when you get a phone call, no problem. I was prepared though, I was expecting that phone call. So I had the little text thing ready. Right, what am I doing? And remove, there we go. Okay, and let's go back to live. Did I miss anything? I got a follower 8 hours ago. Cool, adjust yourself. Mate, I'll try. By the way, I'm a professional. Did you guys know this? I'm a professional streamer. Right, did anything happen in the last minute while I was on the phone? No, we're good, we Gucci. Let me just quickly change that. Discord streamer mode, there you go. Now everyone knows I'm streaming, Lel. Right, what did I miss while I was on the phone? Hello, by the way, everyone. Hello, welcome. Hello and welcome. I don't know how long I can stay. Partners making me tidy the living room. Mara. Fair enough. Questa, doing alright, mate. Thank you. How are you doing, Questa? Fire as well, welcome. Yes, you are early. You are so early, you beat me. let me see. Mindwolf, good to see you as well. Such a friendly chat. Indeed. Let me see, other than being cold as fuck, I think it's a good day so far. Right, pretty, I'm petting my dog and he looks, stop talking! It's auto-scrolling the chat, I can't read it! Okay, Bizzle, I just read that about your dog, that's lovely. Gonna love happy farts. Right. Seems my attempts have been rather lacking because I don't ever recall seeing that dragon head before. Oh wow, Dark Pikachu, welcome dude. This is from... I did this quite a while ago on DeviantArt, actually. I don't think... Oh, I have made a video for it, actually. So it's fucking telemarketers again. Yeah. Right. I used to watch an old TV show called Dragon when I was a kid, and there's a song, I can't remember what it is, but I want to find it. Well, just look up the movie, Mindwolf. You should be able to see all the information then. Professional streamer here. Yep, indeed. Been a hot minute since I last heard you talking. Yeah, Darkened, mate. How you doing? Welcome back. If you've got your headphones, I won't be able... I won't be as talkative. That's okay, Rag. No probs. Right. Okay, and I think I'm all caught up now. Okay then, so. This isn't the dragon head we're working on today. I just chucked it in the, you know, so we had something to look at while we wait. I actually did this a while ago. You talk slower. Talk slower, you sound like you're talking German. I'm sorry. I was very quickly catching up with the chat. I had a phone call just while starting. But yeah, thank you for the reminder. I will try to talk slower. As I was saying, yeah, this isn't the creation that we're working on today. I just had this open up in the background, that way you had something to look at while we were loading or waiting, you know, all that kind of stuff. Pretty good, thank you. How about you? I'm doing all right, thank you, Darkened Pikachu. You're doing all right. Had a bit of a rough week, but doing better. Is that a Bog Sneak head? Yes, it is. This is a Bog Sneak from Flight Rising. Thank you. Where'd it go? Thank you, dude. There's a bunch of episodes I've been trying to find him, but because the names are so generic and the main character's name is literally Dragon, so I'm having a hard time finding it. Oh, right, I see. That kind of blows. Becca could have put fan art there. That is true. Right then. So. Let us not do that. Let us create a new thingy. There we go. And yeah, I am making a particular character, if you will. I know a lot of you will probably recognize it as time goes on. It's not going to be a surprise by the time we figure it out, but yes, I'm drawing someone's character. I'll let you guess who, even though you can probably guess. Right, a Diplo. God, no, I'm not drawing a mate. No, not a Diplo. Do I look like some gross Diplo lover? Do I look a Diplo gas bag? Yeah. Ignitus? Ooh. No, not Ignitus, but I want to now. I definitely want to now. A Diplo dragon, Spyro. I will be doing Spyro at some point. Not today. But I 110% do want to make Spyro at some point. I think that'd be really, really cool and fun. Cinder? Ooh, Cinder would be cool as well, actually. That definitely would be a good one. Draki 2.0. No, that's another thing I need to do, though. I do need to make another Draki. You're definitely right about that. We're doing Mind Wolf's character. There you go. See, Gem get. Okay, what the hell? Stop spinning. There we go. She's. Yes. Guess. Gem guessed it correctly. If you missed it, then, well, you got to wait and see. I won't say it again. But Gem got it right. I'm still very flustered because of that like quick little phone call there. So I'm still trying to remember how to eloquate the English as well as not talking at a million miles per hour. A Diplo gas bag. Mate, I don't even know, but I'm never doing that. I'm never going to do a Diplo gas bag. That'd just be, that'd be horrible. Right then. Go ahead then, and I'm actually going to do myself a favor here. If I mask all that off and what's it again? Chapter? There you go. I've just suddenly forgotten how to do things. Right, there you go. Delete that bit. And let's reactivate. Okay, good. It's already activated. Now I've got a nice flat surface. And then, just to make it easier for myself, I'm going to go ahead and duplicate that. There we go. Can I, like, get... There you go, right, good. On the blue axis, 180, haha. And do that, just because... Oh, actually, let me quickly reactivate symmetry. I kind of forget to do that every now and then. If you ever, like, move a piece before you reactivate symmetry, it can really screw things up. And it's a bit chaotic when that happens. Right then, that looks pretty good so far, pretty good. Speedy shout so I can make it. Welcome back, Larry. Welcome back. Someone commissioned her to make a Diplo gas bag. Hey, I don't wanna. I mean, if you pay me, I will, but I don't wanna. Maybe I don't wanna make a Diplo gas bag. Maybe. I just wanna make happy little trees. And all that good stuff, you know? All that good stuff. Becca forgot something. Wait, did I forget something? Oh yeah, of course I did. But PewDiePie, welcome. Welcome, mate. Good to see you here as well. Nice, I will pay you, joking. I know, I was about to say, I think you're all joking, and then I realized, well, actually, some of you guys are absolute sadists who will pay me to do things just for the joke of it. So I'm not actually sure if everyone's joking or not. I'm gonna choose to believe that you're all joking. All right. Oh, that's okay. Yeah. Actually, if I there's a tool I can use. Is it mirror meld? Okay, that didn't quite do what I wanted to, but that's fine as long as it's by the actually no. Let's go ahead and duplicate that mirror. Merge down. There we go. Now it's properly merged. Yeah, I definitely feel a little bit off today in terms of actually being efficient with this. I feel like I've forgotten half the commands. Eh, we all have an off day, don't we? Yes, yeah, so like one of the monsters from Monster Hunter World. Oh, see, that'd be extremely cool to do a Monster Hunter World creature. That'd also be extremely hard. Imagine that. Like, goddamn. Unless it was like a nice cartoony one, that would be kind of, that'd be a little bit more manageable. But if you wanted like some proper, like, try-hardy, me attempting to do a realistic kind of sculpt from Monster Hunter. Damn! That's all I can say. Damn. It's a turkey. Yes, we're making a turkey. It depends on what part is gas bag and Diplo, there should be a limit. True. Do we want Becky to do it? Oh no. Have I made a mistake? am I about to have huge regrets here, guys? Sounds about right. Diplo gas bag? No, don't. Gas bags are cute, fluffy creatures, and Diplos are just evil, annoying bastards. Clarak, I completely agree. Well said. Right. Is this ZBrush core? Yes, fire. Yes, this is ZBrush core. This is the cheaper, more affordable version of ZBrush. And in my opinion, still extremely good. ZBrush is of course better, but if you're if you've got an affordable version of ZBrush, Core is really, really good to get, in my opinion. It looks exactly the same. What to a turkey? I'll have you know, this looking duckish. I'll have you know that emotional support is the only accepted, is the only acceptable Diplo. Nice. Right, that's looking quite okay so far. Just trying to, you know, get all the shapes to like make some sense. Flow a bit better. I guess it kind of looks, it does look a bit like a duck in a way, doesn't it? Oh, ZBrush called a ZBrush. Ah, right. I see. Well, I mean, So there are like major features in ZBrush that you just simply cannot even attempt in Core, like the sculpture thing, like fiber mesh. Fiber mesh is the thing I really, really want to get more than anything else. But that, saying that though, yeah, I guess you're right. I guess it's not really that different. I can't really comment on it too much because when I used the full version trial, there's a 45-day trial for the full version, and when I used that, I'd never had Core. So I could only, you know, really experience like the surface of it. So I guess you might be right. They might actually just be, you know, very, very similar. The mesh is partially hidden. Yeah, someone just splits the hidden parts. There you go. So yeah, I don't know. I guess I could just be very overly enthusiastic over it. But to me, so like I kind of look at ZBrush as I do Photoshop compared to, say, GIMP. Photoshop can just do more, even though I don't know what it can do yet. So I've always had the impression that ZBrush was just like significantly better than Core. Again, despite not really knowing it just yet. All I know for a fact is I want a fiber mesh. As soon as I get fiber mesh, mate, job done. That tutor from yesterday even will look absolutely amazing. I don't know, you did art on the channel, this is awesome. Hollywood, welcome dude, and thank you. Yeah, every now and then, I decide to do a bit of drawing. Welcome, mate, welcome. YouTube, thank you, PewDiePie. I remember when Becca was almost killed by a Diplo on Crystal Isles, but she didn't realize it deals damage to her. Yep. I remember that one. I remember that all too well. I remember the sheer horror realizing I was about to die to a damn Diplo, because it was a typical standard, like, oh no, I'm dying kind of horror, followed by, oh my god, I am dying to a Diplo. That was definitely a humiliating moment. It was hilarious, but that certainly was a, that was an interesting time, wasn't it, PewDiePie? That was crazy. Not everyone can watch those episodes yet, unless they happened in a live stream. I can't remember. Ah, fair enough. When you're lucky, when your turkey got some Archaeopteryx, it's about to get weird. Well, weirder. And Fire, thank you very much. Thank you. ZBrush actually isn't that bad on the computer. I mean, I don't know what the required specs are for ZBrush, or Core, or whatever. But I've not had any issues at all with it. If anything, I personally get better performance in ZBrush than I do Sculptress. So, you know, it's one of those things, isn't it? It'll probably work out nicely. Right. Should we go ahead and embed all of that in? Have the jawline be a bit larger. In fact, I kind of thought the entire thing might be a bit wide. Yeah, I think it is a bit wide, isn't it? Let's just go ahead then. That's a bit more like it. Let's do the same to that one again then. And then a bit around the neck, maybe? Yeah, make the mech just, the neck just ever so slightly thinner. And that bit there significantly thinner. Okay, that's a bit better. Just a bit. Did I miss my question? Where are you from? I'm from England. In Britain. Which may, you know, explain why I talk so quickly. Because in London, well, I grew up in London, it was definitely a bit of a common thing to talk very fast when you get carried away. I grew up in London. I am currently in the Midlands. You know, keeping it vague, of course. ZBrush probably needs RAM, I guess, but to be honest, if you don't make a high-poly model, then the most computers should be able to run it fine. Yeah, exactly, exactly. Like, if you're into... Like, if you want to... I'm going to hunt you down. Well, you have to get past Kevin first. what was I going to say? Carrick, you're definitely right about that. I was about to say that, but if you're like, if you want to do models for, you know, like doing games and such, or doing animations, the simple fact of the matter is, you are not ever going to make a model that has millions of polygons. Never. If you actually plan on using the model. So you guys always see that I have models that have millions and millions of polygons. Like, I think the highest one done so far was 35 million polygons. That's in an animation or a game or whatever, that just would not work. It would just be too much. So if you were thinking of actually using your stuff, you'd have to get used to, you know, doing things at a lower resolution, a lower polys, all that kind of stuff. And that by definition will then be a little bit more stable for your computer, if you're a bit worried about your computer's performance, of course. Like, hell, my PC lags on 35 million polygons, and to be fair, reasonably so. It should lag that much. In fact, the eyes on this are really awkward. I'm going to try and just embed them a bit further in. It looks quite bulbous. Let me see. Add a bit of a definition there. There you go. My boyfriend's on is now online. Bye, I gotta go play with him and cross out. Fire, enjoy yourself. Enjoy, and I'll catch you soon. Make the mech spaghetti thin. Wait, what now? And as I write my thing, my internet screws everything. Oh, Shagaru. Welcome back, Shagaru. Bloody sucks, doesn't it? Like, when you're in the middle of writing or just as you finish, that's when your internet goes out. That is one of the most annoying feelings. An i5 with 8GB of RAM, you start to notice frame drops at around 20 to 30 million polys. Yeah, that makes sense. I'm not actually sure what the specs of my PC are off the top of my head. You know, I struggle to remember that kind of stuff. But that does sound completely reasonable. Especially as, you know, it's a lot of polygons to begin with. You know, that's really some heavy work. Back at it again. Welcome back, Joseph. It's in the Midlands, actually, most of the country, because I'm sure I've only been out of them when I'm dragged to the bench. Or to the beach. To the bench? I guess... I don't know, actually, now that you mention it. Well, I live near Leicester then, how about that? That area of the Midlands, I live near Leicester. And that is all I will say. Wahaha. Right, let's go ahead then and make your jaw just a little bit crooked, as it's looking a bit too flat right now. Let's go ahead, make that bit there crooked. And give her a bit of a grin. Becca, go home, you're drunk. Yeah, no surprise. No surprise there at all. Mind Wolf, I'm drunk soon. As long as you hide some subtools while you're working on others. Oh, yeah, yeah, I completely agree with that. Completely agree. So, yeah, saying that then. So, going by what Wedigo's saying, if you're like me and you're just making things for the fun of it, therefore you don't care about the polygons and you're not optimizing it, as Wedigo said there, if you are experiencing lag, just hide portions of it. Like, you can very easily hide entire subtools, which are basically layers, like that. Or you can do like control shift left click. You can like select off entire areas like that. It's good. There's definitely ways you can get around it, and just, you know, even if you're doing like the most detailed things in the world, you can still find ways to have your make it so your PC isn't dying. That's essentially what we're getting at. I don't care about polys because I'm never using it, but yeah, exactly. It's just more fun, isn't it? It's more fun just going nuts, essentially. That's what I like doing. And of course, if you ever were to use your things for animation or rigging or whatever, you have to do retopology anyway, so it's not like it makes much of a difference going low res at the beginning. Or ends. You know what I mean. I need to work on more tattoo designs. I don't know why I decided to draw Sleep Now as a tattoo, but you know what? I'm gonna finish it. Later when it's not cold. Mine Wolf at Fair Play. Right. But yeah, of course, everything I say is, you know, through the perspective of an amateur. That's worth keeping in mind. I am only a hobbyist. Hopefully someday more, but for now, I just do these things for fun. Right now, I'm just adding like a bit of a definition of where the horns are going to be. That looks about right, about good. And where to go? Thank you for the follow, dude. Welcome. I don't know why I said welcome. You're already here. But thank you regardless. I do that a lot. I don't know why. Right, let's make the eyes just a little bit smaller. And move those upwards. Make the entire sockets here just move back a bit. There you go, that's much better. It's more like it. Thank you, I'm very happy to be here. I'm glad, dude, I'm glad. Thank you. And Jem, I'll catch you later. Enjoy your meal. You're Northwest, by the way. Nice. Cool. Bear with me, I'm focusing on getting the ridge right. Stumbles in a chat. Here's some advice. Never try rigging animating while on a sugar rush. Oh, God. Yeah, that sounds like a bit of a recipe for disaster there. Welcome, by the way, Sai. While on a sugar rush. I think I've never really had a sugar rush. Like, I've not had one in a bloody long time. Well, then again, though, I do just randomly get, like, completely hyper on life. So I guess that probably counts as a sugar rush. Does ZBrush still do the 45-day trial thing? Since my computer robot refuses to get me on the server at the moment. Yes. Yes, yeah, pretty sure it does, yeah. And you get the... I don't know about the latest version. But when I got the trial, which was about a year or two ago now, it was like the absolute full version at the time. So maybe it'll be the full version now as well, don't know. But yeah, definitely worth getting, definitely worth looking into. Especially if you're thinking about getting core, but money's a bit tight. It's definitely nice just to have the option of trying it out, or trying out like the big version first. It's Godzilla. Hey, Ail. Welcome, bro. I might give it a go later then, as soon as I dust my GPU. Ah, yes. Yes, indeed. But yeah, defo, do so. And I can try to help you, although Cleric would be much better help here. Cleric and a bloody full version. But yeah, I could, like, Mara, you know, I'd be happy to try and, like, just give any advice I can. Although when it comes to, like, certain little specifics or tools or whatever, Cleric may be the better person to ask. One day, all right? One day, I'll get the full one. Mark my words. Once Kara's the sort of going to stay up for it, nice. Do you use any of that, or do you mean any other programs? Not yet. So right now, currently, what I'd like to do is eventually I will be looking into rigging and animating and such, eventually. So to do that, Blender, that's my next choice. Once I learn Read Topology in Blender, and I actually can do it, I'm going to get a subscription for Substance Painter, which looks fantastic. But there's no point in me getting it now until I can do Read Topology. After that then, so after Substance Painter and Blender, I'm not really sure what next, because I want to try out things like Maya, but it's... Oh man, the price. The price. And if I'm using Core... You can imagine, I definitely can't afford Maya. Yeah, Substance Painter looks incredible. It looks so incredibly good. And actually affordable. Like, that's the great thing for me. So, the very moment I learn Read Topology, I'm definitely going to be all over Substance Painter. It's a cheaper version of Maya. Oh, is that really? Oh, wow. Last I heard, I was checking this just yesterday, actually, during yesterday's live stream. £30. Yes, that's right. Oh, wait. Maya for £30? Oh, my God. Okay, yeah, I need to look into that then. Last I checked, it was just the, what was it? It was just the individual license, the studio license, and the student's license, and I can't get student. But if it's £30, though, mate, imagine doing Retopology and that instead. That'd be incredible. $250 a month. Ooh. Yeah. Substance Painter. So, Clarak. Right, Clarak. You'll love this, okay? I'm sure you know what it's like painting in ZBrush. It's good, it's fine. I like painting in ZBrush. Substance Painter is basically, you could probably call it the Photoshop, or like, yeah, painting texturing, the Photoshop for 3D. It supports layers. It supports layers. I think it supports bump mapping. I'm not entirely sure about that one. It looks like it does. It supports, I don't know the technical words for it, but basically, you know how when you see like really low resolution models, but they have all these special bumps and grooves and curves and everything that look like they're high res, but really the polygons are really low? There's a reason, I think it's got like height map or something like that, and that's another thing that Substance Painter supports. So, as well as the colors and the textures, as well as the bump mappers and the layers, you can also do height maps, which give the illusion that your very low res model is actually high res. You'll see that you're like in Arc. Arc is a really, really good example. In Arc, you export a model of a raptor. It's actually quite simple. It's actually quite low res. But you look at a raptor in game, you see how the light reflects off of every individual scale. That is the height map. Again, I may be using the wrong terms here, but I hope you understand what I'm getting at. But yes, yes, layers in 3D texturing. Mate. As I said, like, the very moment I learn how to do Retopology, I am buying a sub for Substance Painter. Like, just no questions, I'm going for it. Because it looks so superior. And so useful. So, like, it looks like you could actually learn it. Not that it would take you a year to figure it out. It actually looks straightforward. ZBrush on Super Saiyan steroids, indeed. And that would happen to be via Wizlinks, would it went? Oh, wait. Oh, Wizlinks, all right. You can do Retopology and Brush, by the way. Oh, can you? I did not know that. I know that, let me see, the Z plugin. I know you can use a Decimation Master. And I know that you can change the Dynamesh, or you can change the Clay Polish tool and all those kind of things and kind of automate it in a way. Yeah, might be the full version indeed. Yeah. Definitely not in my current version, at least. There are, like, the cheap layman's versions, as I've been told. There are, like, the smaller versions that I can do in ZBrush, but they're just not optimal. But it wouldn't be hard to learn, though. Like, if you can do it in Blender, for me, there's no excuse. My only excuse is time. But it is 100% something I will be looking into. Hey, Pedro! Same thing with Spore Pass. The models themselves are rather blocky in polygon, but the textures are added hugely to them. Yeah, exactly. I actually didn't know Spore did the same. I guess it makes sense, actually, the bump maps. But I did not know that Spore did had the same effect. That's good to know. So yes, one day. One day. I want to animate and Blender in the future. Yes, same. I come to think of, actually, on the topic of programs, I think, I don't know how much it costs, but somewhere down the line, maybe KeyShot as well. KeyShot is just good for rendering your stuff and, you know, making it look pretty and polished after you paint them and after you've modeled them, etc. So I think maybe, yeah, KeyShot in the future might be another option. But I'm not looking at that one just yet, you know. Rendering a Blender is so much, KeyShot is so, oh, is it really that expensive? Fair enough then. Like I said, I've not looked into that one heavily yet, because that's a long way away. But I have seen that you can render a Blender, and that... render a Blender. And that does look really good. Yep, this is Nightwish. Yes, it is, Pedro. Yeah, you guys are stuck in my music for yet another stream. Enjoy. Right, that's actually looking very narrow. That's looking a bit too narrow, actually. Let's go ahead and make her jawline a lot higher up like that. Give me a sec, I got a bit carried away and it's all kind of looking a little bit weird now. What is the song called? The song is called Last of the Wilds by Nightwish. Last of the Wilds. Yep, there you go. Thank you, Pedro. Yeah, just quickly doing a bit more on this before I carry on reading. As I said, I got very carried away here. Okay, it's a bit better. And your entire neck actually needs to be quite a bit forward. You're very humanoid kind of head. Or neck, you know what I mean, like the way it's all positioned. Okay, it's better. Right, good. Right, as I was reading, rendering, oh yeah, I've read that. Blender can almost be just as good, and it's free. Yeah, exactly. That's why I want to learn that one first. Definitely. I just need to get over the controls. I have a really hard time learning the controls in Blender, but one day I will bloody learn them. I've been struggling with it for so long. In fact, I've had people tell me this. I should just do myself a favor, stop being lazy, and actually just change the keybinds. That might be good. Substance and Blender is a godly combination. Ah, yes. Yes, it is. I've been watching... I can't remember their YouTube name off the top of my head. It's like Hokiaya or something like that. Four capital letters. And the things they do, they sculpt in Blender. They model and sculpt in Blender. Then they rig it, then they get the texture map, then they do it in Substance Painter, and then they render it and pose it in Blender again, go back and forth. Oh my goodness. The things he does is absolutely ridiculous. It took me 5 years to figure out keyframing, oh god. Right. That, I'm lucky, look at that actually. The snout's a bit narrow though. The snout is a bit narrow, so I do need to fix that. Oh, that's already a huge improvement right there. Good. Liking that. Let's move the jaw down just ever slightly, or ever so slightly, like that. And get the jawline poking out a bit more. Excellent. Right. What will it be? Some kind of dragon? It is somebody. Somebody in this chat is one of their characters. I'm making someone's OC. I'm keeping it vague in case they've not figured it out yet. And I want it to be a surprise. Even though they're definitely going to. In fact, I think they already have. I'm not very good at last minute surprises, am I? Yeah, you figured it out. Okay, bollocks. All right. I'm making mine also OC. It's her birthday today. Which I kind of forgot about. So I'm making her a model of Penya. Robust, I should say. And you know, also a bit of cheeky practice, a bit of cheeky commission practice, of course. But mainly, you know, it's totally mainly the birthday gift. Yeah, I know I've already said who it was, but she was away at the time. What would you say of the pros of using Substance Painter with Blender rather than using Blender alone? I can't find much information to understand. Personally, I'm not really experienced enough to tell you the differences. I've never textured in Blender, so I simply do not know, therefore I cannot comment. All I do know is that painting Substance Painter appears to be just significantly, has significantly more options. But again though, I'm not experienced, therefore I'm not going to comment. Soon. One day, soon, I would be able to answer that question properly. Keybinds, I'm cringing at you clicking the buttons, I'm sorry! Habit! It's a big cause of habits. It actually... It sounds so stupid. I know this sounds really, really stupid. It takes me longer to map out the keybinds and relearn them than it does just clicking on them. Although you are right, I do need to do that. I'm just not going to do it right now. Otherwise, I'll be even slower. I will. I'm sorry. Right. Let's get one more. Make that there a little bit larger and then add another one. Yeah, like, hold on, let me try like S. No, that's a different thing entirely. So I can do that. draw size. Move. Yeah, okay, yeah. I need to learn him properly one day. to make an adaptive skin or preview it. That looks. Let's have a little bit higher. Yeah, that's more like it. Oh god, it's really. Actually, now let's have it. What'll it look like with one? Yeah, that's a good start actually. Make adaptive skin. And then, so I say nice little thing, or duplicate that, delete the original, now I have the option to merge, or duplicate that one again, mirror it, merge down, and then of course, symmetry. Good. Good. Big majestic horns there. Oh my god, why are so many people pinging me? Ah! I've seen a dragon queen that's offered a big sum of gold for one of her dragon lovers. Yes! Yes, you did, didn't she, demon? Good to see you, Balloy dude. Welcome. I finished the video for your Rexay. I nearly said restroom. Damn you guys, talking about Pokemon. Yes, demon, I've finished the video for your Rexay. She's rendered. I will be uploading that after the stream today. Among other things, of course. So yes, nearly done. Alright, let's make that... Good. The Pokemon reignited. That would be interesting. Okay, there we go. So now it's all nice and soft. Go ahead and dynamesh it a little bit more. Making smooth things is the bane of my existence. Mainly because I'm still a noob and I'm still learning things. There we go. That's close enough for now. Nightwish. Right, so yeah, don't listen to them Pokemon Yellow is the best. Don't listen to them Pokemon Heart Gold is the best. They're all wrong. All the games are good. I like that, True Bride. I can get behind that opinion there. I'm only interested in Pokemon because of the first anime and fossils. Yes, of course. The Pokemon Wars just got reconnected. Oh dear, oh dear. Yeah, well, guys. You see, I grew up with Gen 1, therefore Gen 1 is automatically the best. So, yeah. I am older, therefore my opinion? Your opinion's invalid. Absolutely kidding, of course. Absolutely kidding. But you know, Gen 1 is better. I'm kidding. Age check, let's go. Oh god, no. Now you're going to make me and PewDiePie feel old. She's a Gen 1-er. Well, it's Gen 1 and a half. Gen 5 is the best. There's something satisfying about low poly models. Yeah, I have to agree, Larry. I really have to agree. Like, on the one hand, they make me fall impatient. I just want to crack on and do more. But on the other hand, it is quite oddly satisfying, isn't it? I read that as fact. Here it is. The smallest fully functioning human penis in the world is only 1/16th of an inch long. Damn. I really don't know how to reply to that. Like, cool, but I just could not think of anything witty. I tried so hard that I could not think of anything witty. TMI. blame True Bright. He's the one that shared the interesting fact. Well, the fact that he put the facts in quotation marks is making me wonder. Like, oh god. Sorry guys, phone call. Give me a sec. Oh, no, stop. BRB. Okay. Hello, nanny. Right, there you go. Yeah, phone call. Oh shit, the music. I'm glad. Hey, Space Dragon, good to see you again. I'm glad you're enjoying it. I'm sending you a stash link once this bitch finishes loading. Awesome, Man Wolf. Awesome. I just unplugged my headset. There we go. Oh, right. I can't wait to have these cables sorted. I've got bloody cables wrapped all around my feet. I'm back from eating. Welcome back, Gem. And Cam, still good to see you as well. I have around 1500 hours playtime on my Pokemon Silver at Game Boy Color. Goddamn. And True Bride, yes, of course, the server. Guys, this ARC sub-server for a mere $5 per month to subscription, you too can join the ARC sub-server among many other things, such as early access to videos. I have an itchy eyebrow. Oh god, that's really distracting. And you know, all that good jazz. All that stuff. Oh, I like this song. I've not heard this song in a while. Right, so let's give you some big spiky eyebrows because you are a spiky girl. Although they look kind of terrible, just a low. Yeah, actually, we'll do that later. You suck at sellout. Yes. That's why you do it for me, Ayo. That's why you sell out for me, because I'm terrible at it. Right. I'm thinking. God damn it, Ayo. That was beautiful. What song is that? The song playing right now even is Give Me Your Soul by King Diamond. Give Me Your Soul. 25 is halfway to 50 and 50 is more than halfway to death. Yes. Yes, that is very true, Rag. Thank you. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and just double up the resolution here. More like triple. And let's make things a little bit cleaner. Right then, good. Now, first things first is... Let me see. First things first is... Let's get a bit of definition around the eyes. So something like that. The eyes here are a little bit embedded like, so they're kind of like that. So I'm doing a very poor job explaining or describing, but you know, bear with me. If you're looking from below, I only get Demon Goat vibes. I sent it out a huge file so Discord wouldn't want to send it. Alright, thank you, Mind Wolf, thank you. I won't check it out now because I reckon that doing the main, you know, the main body will take quite a while. But I will definitely be checking it out when I get into the greater detail, Mind Wolf, so thank you very much. Thank you! Good for me! Right. Alright, cool. That's looking alright so far. So far, so good. Let's go ahead and try that again, actually. More like... Oh, there you go. That's a bit of a better outline. Although it's a little bit deep in, but it's still quite fine. Like I said, make it easy in the long run. Thank you very much. Draki Lady, good to see you, Draki. Larry, the only downside to the more modern Pokemon games is that there's so many Pokemon, it's hard to catch them or care for them all. Yes. Yes, indeed. I came here only to see the break screen and my most accurate spider drawing with most people saying Pokemon Gen is the best. Alright, Jackie, I've just seen that all now. Welcome, good to see you. What a great, great timing. Right. I'm doing the same thing I did yesterday where I just randomly go very silent. I do apologize. This seems to happen a lot when I'm drawing, doesn't it? Like, not when I'm creating the spore, no, just only when I'm drawing. I just randomly go completely silent. I just want my old Game Boy back with my Sapphire and Emerald and Leaf Green games. Mate, that'd be awesome. Tell her to stop smothering me in love. I don't deserve it. Mine Wolf. We're all smothering you in love. Fuck you. You do deserve it. Look, Mind Wolf. Right, Mind Wolf, look. You're being smothered in love because people like you. So fuck you for being a nice person. It's obviously all your fault. You deserve it, you big meanie. Deal with it, mate. No, I don't care if you're a meme or not, you deserve it. Shut up. Take our love. Take it. You have been told. And by the way, Jackie, your drawing of Penny was amazing. I forgot to say. You always struggle with ram horns on dragons? Yes, ram horns are really complicated, aren't they? They definitely are quite tricky to do. Faithful. You see, you know. Take our love, I'm gonna hug you, oh god. This must be one of the most aggressively nice streams or communities. Right. Actually, how does the jaw even look? Okay, yeah, that jaw needs a bit of work. Need to increase all of that. I just realised, so I really probably should start advertising these drawing streams on DeviantArt now that I've got the commissions page going. Which, by the way, I think might be done. I'm going to finish some things first, such as Peekify's creation. That needs to be finished first. But I think my commissions page is pretty much done. I don't know if I'm missing anything. I've been trying to figure it out, but I think I'm fine. Right, good. Now then, let's go ahead then and just remove everything. EXE acquired targets. Again, which one? I am thinking PewDiePie. I think I might do both of them. Mainly because I feel really bad it's taking me so long. But I think I'm going to do both of them for you. Right, get rid of all of that. A little bit more, actually. I just want to cover you in love essence. Oh. That could be greatly misconstrued, just so you're aware. Okay. Kinky. Mag, I'll catch you later, mate. Good seeing you. And have a wonderful day. Yeah, that came out wrong. Yeah, just a bit, mate. Just a bit. I've actually started to get better ram horns since we started drawing them. It just takes a bit of getting used to. Yeah, it does, doesn't it? It does just take a bit of getting used to, doesn't it? It's like every other thing in, you know, just in life and drawing and such. It just takes practice. Just lots and lots of practice. 50 shades of wrong. Hey. Wait, what? No. We don't need to run. We can just bulldoze through crowds of people. Wow. Crystal. Savage. PewDiePie, or is it just intended? Alright, there we go. Actually created a bit of a nice texture there as well. That's pretty cool. Let's go ahead then and just flatten that out a bit. It's not meant to be that pointed. Wait, stop. There you go. And I do just want to have a bit of a subtle bump on the cheekbone there. There you go. It's just something very subtle, but just makes it look a lot less flat. Right, so we've got that there. Do the same thing again on the lower jaw. So what resolution is that? It's currently 120. Right. Set that one to 120, 128, whatever. Close enough. There we go. Oh no. 50 shades of love essence. 50 love of essence. 50 essences of love. 50 love, 50 of essence. What the hell am I reading? Oh my god! Even though chat just broke! Didn't realise you guys are into love essence so much, Jesus. Yes, system of down. Indeed, space, indeed, man. Mine all for you. Wait, mine all for you are not old. This is getting worse and worse by the second. Yeah, bloody is, isn't it? But that's fine, though, that's fine. You know, if you guys can keep yourselves entertained whenever I undoubtedly just zone out while drawing, then that's good. Oh, whoops. Actually, nah, let's get that back. That wasn't necessary. There we go. If I get any love, I'm gonna give it away to Mind Wolf. Nice. Zenith, Mind Wolf is... I'll let her say, actually, in case she doesn't want me to say. And Kakadu, welcome as well. Spider Planet 2, welcome, guys. Becca thought I was 23 when we met, so that doesn't help. No, Mind Wolf. The fact that I thought you were 23 doesn't mean you're old. It means you're mature. There's a difference. There's a very, very big difference there. Right, that's looking pretty cool as well. That means I'm old. Well, fuck you then. Right. Rebecca also thought I was older. I don't know how old exactly. Probably 20s as well. In fact, Jackie, if I'm going to be honest, I've forgotten your age. So I'm still guessing like 20s. Like early, mid-20s is what I'm guessing right now. I'm older than Mind Wolf. True, right? Help. I'm older than most of my community. It's scary. Like, I'm used to being the youngest, but lately I've been the oldest. It bloody sucks. And I know I'm probably making PKFA rage. I'm sorry, dude. I'm sorry. I don't mean to. But I'm used to being the youngest. Damn you guys. Damn you young people. Be old and cranky like me. The Drac is about half a year closer to death than Mip. Oh, Jesus Christ, Ayo. Bloody hell, man. It looks like a Nightwing from Wings of Fire. Huh. That's pretty cool. Right. Oh, okay, then. I don't know what that sound was. That was weird. Right, I'm gonna do a bit of the horns, or about the skin around the horns. I'm gonna start making some teeth. 22 in January, time to die. What? How did the chat just suddenly get so morbid? I'm close to 14, less than a year from it. Okay, shit, that reminds me. Let's not talk about age. I just remembered something very important. So I honestly forget this frequently. Because the stream is tagged 18 plus, technically, if you are less than 18 years old and you're watching my stream, you can get banned. I just remembered that. I honestly forget, so if you don't want to be banned, don't say your age. You know, I like a lot of you guys, but I have a responsibility to ban young people. So please don't make me ban you. Ninja mode activated, yeah, indeed. That's something I really need to remember, actually. That's serious. Right, let's go ahead and get rid of all that for a sec. Let's make that symmetrical. I always forget that stage first. There you go, make that smaller. I'm 20, so I'm good. Good. Right. See, if you're older than 18, feel free, man. Like, talk about how you guys are, like, fellow mature individuals. Right? But if you're less than 18... don't get me in trouble. Basically. I feel old as fuck. Mature, she says. Well, I mean... shut up. Right, let's go ahead and increase resolution on that too, fair. There we go. Also, Becca, make this cartoon square teeth instead of the normal one. Why? I'm not gonna... Why? Ale? I'm not gonna make cartoony square teeth. No. Right. Do that quickly. Right. We'll see where I normally do this. I think I should go ahead and do it like that. I've actually not made teeth in quite a while. I've kind of forgotten how I do it. I remember how I do it. It's the wrong piece entirely. That's why. Screw that bit then. Let's try that again then, shall we? I've been using the cones lately. No wonder why I forgot how to do it. Do that then, make it significantly smaller, make it a lot thinner. There you go, more like it. Dynamesh. Actually, too soon. There you go. Okay, that's a bloody snake fang right there, Jesus. There you go, that's much better. More what I'm after. Damn it, maturity doesn't range from ages, from experience, and differing viewpoints. Thank fuck, I'm 18. I completely agree. I completely agree. I'm chucking the word maturity right now. There are, of course, like, there's of course 40, 50, 60-year-olds who are completely immature. And there are, of course, 13-year-olds who can be surprisingly mature. I entirely agree. I am chucking the word mature around because I'm just having fun. I'm not really thinking about my terminology right now. But, Faithful, I do entirely agree with you. Your maturity doesn't range from age, it's from experience and viewpoints. It's from perspectives, it's from being able to judge things. Or, you know, judging scenarios, you know, that kind of bollocks. Like, hell, I don't even know if I'm mature. I know I can be, but I don't know if I even am. I guess one thing that does show maturity is being able to make a decision based on circumstances and not just because. You know, being able to, like, critical thinking, that kind of stuff. Or not thinking about yourself. That can be another ish kind of sign. Obviously not defining, but an example. Where is Kev when you need him? Is anyone here older than me? Where's Kev when you need him? You cheeky sod. Kev's at work at the moment. Wow, peek-a-bye. Way to just chuck Kev under the bus. Right, there we go. That is not a bad tooth. It's looking a little bit awkward, actually. Yeah, I really don't like just how narrow it gets to the end of there. So if I go ahead then and use a polish. Okay. We thought Snow was 30, at least I did. Yeah, mind off, you thought Snow was 30. I think a lot of us could probably agree that we thought Snow was in his 20s. Definitely didn't think he was 30. Ah, Mind Wolf. Right, what happens then? So now I've got a bit of a shape going for it. If I was to reduce the dynamesh now, no, it'd be a bit too angular. What if I clay polish it? I bloody love this tool, by the way. Ever since it was introduced to me, I've absolutely fallen in love with the clay polish tool. That's a bit too much. That's not bad, actually. Alright, I quite like that. This is the only stream I can watch without being bored. I'm very glad about that, thank you. Especially considering I try to do different content. The fact that you don't get bored when I do different content, that's fantastic. I'm very, very glad to hear that, so thank you. That's brilliant. Right, duplicate. Wait, what the hell? Okay, that just completely went weird. Right, delete that one quickly. Accurate symmetry. Okay, good. Spinning the camera a bit too much there, I apologize. Okay, yeah, I'm just gonna do it that way, aren't I? Oh, what the hell? It's masked. That's why. There we go, that's better. It was kind of just like being very heavily deformed for a moment there. Turn dynamesh off entirely. Unmask. There we go. So now if I move it, good. It's not distorting horribly anymore. That's a bit of a silly little thing there, but hey. Do that, and yeah, we'll just have that for now then. Too true. That's a fang, right? Because it kind of looks like a banana turned edgy. Yes, it's a fang. Thanks, mate. Banana turned edgy. What the hell? You sound like a drowning robot for a minute. Oh. That sucks. I've got no idea why. Right, there we go. So now then, for the teeth on this thing. Basically doing it just the same way Vera has it in her character. Let me go ahead and just do myself a favor. Hide the eyes, hide the horns. Don't want to hide lower jaw. Nah, not yet. I'll hide that one too, actually. There we go. Right then. So how has she got it set up then? So these teeth here are actually quite large. In fact, she's got a much smaller one right there. The teeth are a bit angular. A bit, probably a little bit blocky in a way, but kind of going for a bit of a stylized appearance, so I'm not really that bothered yet. I can always change it later if it's a bit of an issue. All right, another large tooth right there, or tooth even right there. Good. Make it just slightly smaller. I started a Rex Skull 3D printer before I left school to go to a college and put a few hours. Apparently the middle schoolers started to stick a pencil in the print and the whole thing's ruined. Oh, what? Fuck. Rag, that sucks, man. I had to reread that there. Man, that really blows. I'm sorry to hear that. Bloody kids, innit? That really blows. Beat those kids any discipline. Well, no comment. Those are real pacemates or dino teeth. I was over an Allosaurus one. Right, mind off, I was wondering about that. Thank you. Yeah, I saw your reference for it. So, honestly, before the stream, I went and looked back and checked all of your work in progress pictures. I saw the skull. It didn't look like a T-Rex, so I was a little bit confused. It was an allo, good to know. But yes, thank you. I'm still gonna yellow in the teeth regardless. Like, I think my teeth are probably a little bit exaggerated, but unless it bothers you, I think I'm gonna keep it that way for now. Bloody kids, get off my lawn. Yeah, indeed. And peek-a-bye, dude, enjoy yourself, enjoy your meal, and I will hopefully see you soon. If not, as always, mate, it's good seeing you. And I'll probably see you tomorrow instead. Yeah, that really does suck, man. Rag, I'm just thinking about that. Kind of annoying how it just seems to be a bit of a thing lately, just to keep on vandalizing things. Especially, you know, a 3D model being printed. That just... That sucks. Right, so that's going to be a little bit awkward to fix up later on, because they're currently going a bit of a weird angle. I'll do all that shortly. Wow, the teeth actually are exaggerated. Jesus. I may have made them a bit too big. They do look kind of ferocious. Wouldn't that be omnivore teeth, mine? Oh, wait. I mean, I wanted her to have a bit of a special kind of teeth because her father was a herbivore and her mother was carnivore. Guys, please don't ask, but I said, fuck it. Mate, it's your character. You do what you want. There's no reason it has to be absolutely realistic. Like, for all you care, what you could do if you really, really wanted to is give your dragon a Pomeranian tail. I mean, there's nothing saying that you can't. That's my opinion. But I hope the teeth I'm making then aren't too far off of what you wanted. Well, I'll admit mine are a bit stylized as well. I tried drawing for 3 days, got tired of trying to draw it. Fair play, fair play. It wasn't one model, it was a scan from one from, sorry. It wasn't one I modeled, it was a scan of one from a museum. That's fair, but from what I understood, what you said, is it, you know, it is a little bit hard for me to take in all of what I read in the middle of a stream. But regardless, from what I'd understood and what you wrote, it sounded like you had a 3D model being printed and they screwed it midway, right? Or at the end. Whether or not it's yours, that's still an absolute dick move. Or is it like your model, your print? You know what I mean. You know what I mean. Very, very bad at talking. Oh, God. I would say that one day I'll get better, but I've been saying that for about 2 years. Alright, that's a bit of an interesting thing going on. I will add just one little tooth down here, just because it's looking a little bit weird with that one. Okay, good. Now then. For the bottom jaw. Oh, whoops. For the bottom jaw. Let's go ahead and do that right then. So for the bottom jaw, her teeth are still quite large and quite curved. So about the same kind of style. Is that about the right angle? Yeah, about right. Do you like Judas Priest? Yes. Yes, I do. I haven't listened to all of their albums. But I do like, what was it, the few songs by them that I do have in this playlist I really, really like. Such as Electric Eye and Hellion. I really like them too. Oh, a band. Yes, it's a band. And I used to done a Headbull reference to parts of her body in reference from Dinosaurs. Yeah, it definitely starts to feel like that the teeth I'm using now are getting a little bit too flat. On a boss without headphones, it's hard to keep track of what's been said. I was planning on using it as reference for a model I'm working on. Ah, no problems, Rag. No problems, dude. Right, yeah, I see. I stand by what I said. It absolutely sucks, dude. I just really hope it didn't cost you anything. Or if it did, that they'll, you know, help you out with another one. That's what I'm hoping for. Okay, so overall the bottom teeth get a bit large towards the middle, and otherwise they very quickly start to get a bit small after that. So we'll do that, have one there. I haven't decided yet how I'm going to actually embed them in, if I'm going to like give it gums or not. But obviously gums, if I'm going to give it lips or not. I think I might actually, I think I probably will. Is that the right thing? Let's put it out just a little bit. There we go. And make a dragon on the fly or from a reference picture? From a reference picture. I can happily put it up if you guys want to see it. I forgot to do it at the start, which is my bad. But yeah, I'm drawing it from a reference picture that Mindwolf created. Welcome back, Ayo. Mate! You can't say, I'm back, and then say to yourself, welcome back, I'm dead. You can't say, oh, hi, back, you know what I mean. You can't say that. What a dad joking yourself. Right, that's looking quite okay, actually. It's exaggerated. The teeth are exaggerated. But I do like it. It's actually a bit terrifying. I'm cooking burgers. Oh, nice. Again, did that yesterday. Can we see a reference? Yes, sure thing. Give me a sec then, guys, and I'll show you the reference. Those teeth are scary. Right, so what we're going to call this one, we'll just make a new folder for Pena. Right. Give me one Uno Memento, friends. Let's do that. Fortunately, I've got two Discord. Oh, Mindwolf, you PM'd me. Ah, your stash. Nice one. Right. Just chuck it in there for now. Alright, Discord. Grab that image quickly. Where is it? There it is. Wait, open! Save! I want to save the image. Oh god, my other piece is crashing. There it is. Load. Alright, save image as. Just so I can download it. Good enough. Do all that. Right, Streamlabs. Let's go into the editor. Let's go into studio mode. Never mind, don't need to. Right. Let's get you guys an image. I'll call it reference. Downloads. There it is. And I will chuck that. I'll chuck it down here. Let me see, that's about a good size, right? Yeah, that's fine. That's good. Okay then. Right. Now let's get all of those back no longer being hidden. I quite like that. It's definitely looking very angry. That's a habit I always have, but I'm liking how it's going so far. Flame, stop torturing us with good food. I'm drooling all over here. Whenever I sort of burst, my mother said, his birthday on Friday, come over Saturday and we'll have Sunday. Larry, that is amazing. Where to go? Welcome back, dude, and thank you. I've got to go, phone's about to die. Good luck with the stream. Like, hands up for setting out so far. Rag, thank you, dude, and I'll see you later. a modding in Dellahead 2, but in Roblox Studios. It's actually pretty good when you learn how to use it. That's awesome. Cool. That's very cool. I made it for my dragon to see the hollow, like a crocodile alligator. Wait, they're hollow? I actually didn't know that. That's when it gets too big and fall out. There's another tooth underneath our pages. So there's actually a tooth could be. Ah, oh, that's cool. I actually had no idea that was a thing. That's very cool. Right. Let's go ahead. Let me see. Can I make this easy for myself? Can I just go ahead and mirror and weld? No, I cannot. Oh well. Let's just duplicate it then. I need to figure out how that properly works, but this is more than good enough. And the front teeth, there's a bit of a gap in the front teeth. That's actually not too bad, that gap. That's fine. God, it does look horrifying, doesn't it? Jesus. Right, what can I do next? I think I have to mask it. Ah, possibly, actually. Man, those teeth are horrifying. I do actually want to go ahead and move the bottom ones ever so slightly. And did that distort anything? Nope, looking pretty good. It's a commission. It's more of a gift. Although this would be a great example as for a commission. But this one here definitely is more of a gift. Girl, can I play a constant regret like shark teeth? But think about it, unless a tooth was snatched out recently, how many gator mouths do you see with teeth? I mean, it makes sense. Like, I understand the idea that they have like more teeth constantly growing, like sharks, as you said. I understand that. I should know they were hollow. I wasn't aware that was a thing. But it's very cool though. A free commission. Yeah, pretty much actually. This is basically a free commission. It's practice, it's an example, it's a gift, it's free. But it's still a commission in a way. Like, you know, a nice, happy, relaxed commission. Right, the teeth, or the jaw actually, let's make that a little bit more flatter. Like that, let's make that actually a little bit rounder, there you go. Jaw's looking good regardless, looking good from every angle. Right then, interesting. When one does not bend correctly, an exercise is madness. Wait, what now? Now I just want someone to have hollow. Now I just want someone to have hollow teeth or fangs, just to pull out for charms and trinkets. Damn. Stay away from my tooth. Right. Don't set up before people on for exposure here. Oh God. Yes. You're right. Actually, no. Minewolf paid me 500 quid for this. Minewolf paid for this. It's just a very late birthday gift. She has purchased commissions before, therefore this is a loyalty bonus. Actually, she has. So that's actually not entirely false. She actually has. So that works out quite nicely. Right. And the eyes there are looking a little bit sad. Let's go ahead and just pull that out. Like that. That's looking even more, it looks distressed. Okay. I'll just undo all that. I don't think quite $500, but that will happen on stream soon. Damn it, I didn't mean 500. I just pulled the number out my ass. Damn it, Mind Wolf. I wasn't preparing for that. Right, I do feel like these bits here are a little bit too defined. There you go. Let's be a bit more subtle. Right. I'm kind of reached that point now where all I can really do next is just the harder details. Not the harder, the more pronounced details. What I do need to do actually is add some scales, not scales, protrusions on the heads. So I, oh actually, the chisel tool might be good for this. Let me see, chisel creature. Think probably that one there will be suitable for this. Oh yeah, perfect. got like one there, doesn't it? In fact, I'm probably gonna wanna. I don't wanna increase the resolution. Nah, not yet, not yet. Let's add that back in then. And Fernando, thank you for the follow, dude, and welcome. Right, let's have another one. A bit higher up, I'd say, about there. One there. And the final one, quite far forward, actually, around there. That looked kind of funky, actually. It's not too far off, but it looks a little bit weird. Let's see if I can just move them forward. Actually, nah, okay, no. Not yet. Higher resolution. What else? 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 Ah, got no choice. Let's go ahead and increase resolution now. There we go. Not that's a bad thing, of course. I just don't want to do it prematurely. So increasing the resolution prematurely, and then finding that you're missing major things can be a bit of a pain. Just a little bit. Okay, that's more like it. Yep, that's better. Gonna just smooth it all out, that way it's not terribly thin. I got a cat on my side needing me. Mate, Mind Wolf, you love the cat's attention. Right, I can make all those pretty neat later on. Draki, darling, your perceptiveness is astounding. Sigh, are you in an abusive relationship with Blender? Blender can be aggressive, why don't you treat it right? Or when you don't treat it right? Jesus. Well then, Sigh, you know what you gotta do then, mate? You gotta be nice to Blender. You gotta treat it out to dinner, give it a good time. You know? I was gonna say more, but I'm not very witty, so I can't think of any more. Pretend I said something witty. There you go. And it'll be nice to you. I always notice things. And Spider Pilot, I'll catch you later, dude. Thank you very much for stopping by. Right, let's go ahead and just define the nose a little bit more. Let me see. Try and get the right kind of effect here. There we go, that's better. And then pinch all that up. Move it all to be a bit higher. Why are you shipping me with a 3D modeling program? What is shipping anyway? I hear a lot of people say about how, like, they're being shipped. Or whatever. Is shipping like what people just say nowadays for, pairing with someone? Like, being a couple? Because when people say shipping, I just imagine that they're being handcuffed against their will and just put on a ship, and the ship just goes away. You can tell I'm getting old. But don't ask questions you don't want the answers to. Alright, fair. Fair. I stand by what I said though. It sounds like you're just being like shipped off to sea. Yeah, shipping is pairing. Okay. And why don't they just call it pairing? Like kids in a lingo nowadays. That word that young people use these days, exactly, Psy-Explender. All right, Psy-Explender. Guys, I've been getting a very strange surge of one particular request on YouTube lately. I don't know why. Right, so you guys know me, okay? You know me. I don't do any of that shipping stuff. I don't do couples and whatever. It's just like, eh. And yet, despite that, I've been getting a lot of requests, I think from one person, I'm not actually sure, asking for me to make, very simply, for me to make Toothless X Light Fury. And I read that comment and I'm just immediately drawn to thinking, like, are you asking me to make porn? Is that what's going on right now? Are you, do you want me to make, like, you know? I don't know. I don't understand it. Yeah, NSFW, yeah. Like, I honestly don't know if they mean just like a very innocent little paired creation thing, which I've never done anyway, so I don't know what they're expecting. Or if they actually do mean like something NSFW. I honestly, like, if I did that kind of stuff anyway, I'd understand. You know, I'd understand it, but I don't. So I'm wondering, like, why are they asking me when I have no prior experience or examples of that kind of stuff? It doesn't mean porn most of the time. Well, it didn't really give me any other indication. Burgers are good, I agree. Burgers are very good. Oh no, it's just... I keep getting the comments and it's weird. You messed your message again. I'm sorry, dude. A lot of people are talking. So my friends are trying to shit me with another friend that always does gay jokes by jumping on people. Help. That's weird. Most of the time, and most likely with that context, is an instant picture of them together. Oh, okay. Okay, that's fair. Still weird though, as I've never done like couples creations or whatever. But that does make more sense. Like, how would I even do that in Spore anyway? Like, what? Do I just make like two creatures, just shove them in the adventure editor, have them posed together and job done? Is if that's what it is, if that's all it is, all people expect from me, fuck, I could make a fortune. That'd be like the easiest content ever to make. Just take two creations I already have, shove them together, just stand side by side. Maybe I'll make one of them laugh or something. Record that for like 10 minutes. And then, there you go. There's your creation done. Pretty much. Wow. I gotta say, it's extreme. It's almost upsetting. Just how the popular content nowadays on YouTube is also the lowest effort content. Like, it's making me very, very torn. Because on the one hand, I can keep on creating, like, individual characters and such. Or on the other hand, I can take old creations I've already made, play them in the same stage 10 times, and get more revenue and views. It's... yeah, it's a very... very mixed thing. Use a swoon command. Exactly, exactly. Oh god, imagine... oh no, Draki. Imagine this. Right? I make a video. I simply make a video of like a tooth fairy. What? A toothless and a light fury. And it would simply state in the title, toothless uses swoon on light fury. It's very literal. That's all it is in the video, is I use a swoon command, so it just like does a little heart thing, and it doesn't actually do or show anything. It's just like it animates and float, dances or something. But imagine that in the title. Imagine the sheer amount of views that would get. I'd also lose all dignity and self-respect. But that'd be a lot of views, just saying. Those are not great looking teeth at all, are they? Right, just do that, do that. Do the same thing up here then. What I come back to. Just the same old normal stream. Isn't it Paul most of the time? Lots of chat, like 99.99% was most of the time. Like hugging each other or something, I see. Yeah, from what I've seen on YouTube sometimes, promotes things that you'd not expect to be good. You can make a clickbaity low effort video titled Spore 2 with was announced, not clickbait, Jowie in real life, and get mad popular immediately. Like the entirety of YouTube. Yeah, yeah, pretty much. Pretty much. And sometimes big channels start caring about money, and money only which sucks. Don't go through that route, Becca, keep being awesome. Thank you, Kakado. Yeah, yeah, so that's the thing, isn't it? Like, on the one hand, you can keep like trying to do content, like legit content, but it does take a lot of time and all that kind of stuff. Or you can make an easy video and just get rich. Buddy, it sucks. Ah! You're forgetting, oh, by the way, welcome, this is Crafter. You're forgetting the part where you've had gone wrong, gone sexual in the unit at the end of the video. Oh my god, imagine, oh Jesus Christ. Yeah, so imagine that, my little Night Fury analogy, right? So imagine, yeah. I spawn in the two dragons, you know, I use the swoon command, which again does absolutely nothing. I put that in the title, he used swoon. Gone wrong. And the gone wrong part is very simply, Godzilla shows up and kills them. That could be all it is. Or gone wild. Again, Godzilla just shows up and kills them. Maybe that could be the new meme on my channel. Godzilla just appears and kills everyone. That'd be good. That's a meme I can get behind. So I've got the entirety of reaction channels. Also, my mum has been busy lately, so like as a food lot, we'll be getting fried hamburgers and pizza. Now she was guilty or not, cooking made tacos. Oh, bless your mum. Spoil crush has gone sexual. Accidentally adds a limb near the crotch area. Yeah, pretty much. Can I just make a 1 minute video of you Fortnite dancing on the camera, also mentioning all the hit memes get 100 million views? So, Banira, right, Banira. Sorry, I just saw what you said. Right, Banira. So that's a funny thing, right? This is going to sound very vain, I apologise. But, guys, if you were to Google my username in Google. Wow, funny that, Googling Google. Search Dark Edge TV in Google and see what the other results are that appear, like, as you're writing it. The top... Or was it like two or three of the top ones are face reveal, and something else along that line. Those are some of the highest viewed search results, or highest searched results of typing my name, face reveal. So yes, Banira, imagine if I did record a 1 minute Fortnite dance. All right, face reveal in the title. Face reveal, finally. Darkest TV face reveal, Fortnite dance, memes. Fucking hell, imagine that. It's actually a bit of a scary thought knowing that could probably go a bit nuts just by having my face there. Again, I know it sounds very vain, I apologize, but the last time I had such a highly searched for thing was the Let's Plays. I had a lot of people search, you know, Darkest TV Let's Play, season one, episode one, whatever. When I finally did make it episode one, 200k views, day one. I had never seen anything like it. That was the most views I'd ever gotten in a short amount of time. So imagine abusing that with other search results. Spore Toothless User Swoon, Gone Wrong, Gone Sexual, hottest video on YouTube after Trainer Dragon MSW with face cam and commentary. See, what's great, Sai? What's great? Is that right there is so grossly over the top, it'll be so obviously satirical, I hope, on my channel, that I could probably actually get away with that without much damage. That's a crazy thing. Because I think most people on my channel know by now that whenever I do something clickbaity, it's normally satirical. Such as a Spino. Well, actually, I take that back. A lot of people took that seriously. But most people knew it was a joke. You know, most of them knew. And the top results are face reveal. The top results are face reveal and fan-made creations. Oh, that's cool. I didn't know that one. That's really cool. Just have a SFM video of a Jowie doing the default dance to get rich off of it. That's how YouTube works after all. Oh, no. Imagine. I'm honestly tempted. I just want to see what happens. That's actually really, really tempting. Because I'd, like, no joke, right? If I was to do just, like, some silly dance, that would actually be, like, from a productive point of view. You know, having a, like, trying out animations, learning all that kind of stuff, and, like, making my character dance would actually be, like, a very good from a, from, you know, being productive. I could just happen to make the dance a Fortnite dance, and just happen to get a million views. That is kind of tempting. in a very disgraceful and shameful way. Oh, let's change that. There you go. I don't know what I'm doing right now. I'm just kind of like just doodling all over this and just adding just noise, which isn't a bad thing by far, but kind of just going a bit nuts. The famine crisis results in popularity may be skewed because I've actually searched that. Oh, right. I see. Oh, that's cool though. That's cool that you searched this. A duckmaid, welcome. This is ZBrush Core, the smaller, cheaper version of ZBrush. Welcome, dude. If you would make a gel do a Fortnite dance, I'd low-key unsub. You know what, mate? I don't blame you, Bizzle. I do not blame you. I think if I was going to make a Jawi do any kind of dance, what kind of dance would I do? I know. If I was to make it dance in any way, I would make it dance the same way that Rick Astley does in Never Gonna Give You Up. That's the kind of thing I would do. That's definitely me. All the Macarena. Yeah, all that. Can animations of sport be changed? That is a good question. Not by default, maybe via modding. I don't actually know. I wouldn't unsub, I would just be severely disappointed. Yeah. I understand, Jackie. To be fair, I would be as well. I would dance along a Rickroll damn that's old. Hell yeah, man. Just like me. Cute, cute. I'm a player. Radical mate is fine. Via modding, yes. Yeah, probably then. I'm not sure. Next thing you know, Rebecca becomes corrupt and clickbaits for views. Hey, man. I do occasionally attempt to clickbait. But you know what's sad? When I occasionally try to clickbait, such as the bacterioid video saying, like, you know, the 2D aquatic stage. Guys, go look at the views on that video. Go compare that to my other videos. Clickbait works and it's depressing. In fact, I'm curious. Let's go look for a sec. So my average views nowadays, I get about 2k views on a new video, which sucks compared to what I used to get. So average 2k views. Right now, my bacterial video after a day has 14k views. Yeah, clickbait works. Stupid YouTube piece of shit website. I'm going back. Imagine a jam with the WoW Raptor animations. Oh, that'd be so cool. Imagine if the arc animations. I don't really get some of the memes from nowadays. Banira, neither do I. I really don't understand the majority of memes nowadays. Like, as some of you may already know, the fact that I don't allow memes on my channel in Discord makes me feel kind of shitty, because I feel like I'm just suppressing what a lot of people are into nowadays, so I feel like that's kind of dickish on my part. But then again though, Banira, like you said, I just don't get them. Like, on the one hand, yeah, exactly, the search on a grape thing, I agree, like, why is that a meme? Like, on the one hand, you know, it kind of blows that people can't really have fun in the way that a lot of people are used to nowadays, so I feel bad for that, but on the other hand, if I were to just let people just spam shitposts all day on my server, one, obviously it would be annoying. I think a lot of you can agree on that. But mainly, two, I just can't connect, you know? I have a Discord server to talk to people. If every time I spoke to someone, I just replied to a shitpost or an image, I can't connect. I can't respond to that because it's just not my thing. I honestly think if I were to ever allow shitposting on my server, all annoyances aside, I probably just would not be able to converse with people. I probably couldn't talk to you guys, so I just would not know how. You got quite a strong channel. Bloody hell, thank you, dude. Thank you. You have mainly a YouTuber. I say mainly, I'm kind of converting to streaming more and more nowadays. But yeah, not a bad channel going. More games than it is art, but still. I'm glad you don't allow memes or shitposting. Oh yeah, like I'm like on a more on a bias note, I love that I don't allow it. You know, it's just annoying to look at. But on a more professional level, I'm also glad I don't, because it means I can actually interact with you guys and actually have a conversation. And that is like from a from a business perspective, being able to connect to people is significantly more important than just letting you guys have fun and spam memes and shit. You know, it's more beneficial that way. And it's, of course, a lot more sane and a lot more enjoyable. I significantly really, really love being able to talk to you guys on the server and not worry that someone's just going to jump in and just, you know, deter it with a meme. Exactly, Sagasol. Well said. Exactly. I know it's a very unpopular opinion. I know most people just want to spam shitposts. But like I say, there's a million other servers for it. I feel like I'm preaching. I apologize. I'm really not trying to. I just got a bit carried away there. The most recent one... I've read that one. 2k views. It's only 1% of your subscribers. Yes. Yes. So I'm very grateful for the views I do get, of course. But the fact that I used to get... So to put it in perspective, guys, for those of you who... So I don't really talk about this very often because I fear it's ranting. I fear I'm complaining. But... what was it? This time last year, I would get about 25,000 views per day. So about 50,000 views every... I'd get about 50,000 views per day. So on the average 2 days, 48-hour period, I get about 100k views. On the average weekends, about a year ago, I'd get about an average of 150k views on the weekends. Nowadays, I've been dropping as low as 10k views a day. From 50 to 10k. It hurts. It definitely hurts, which is why you guys can see I'm pushing things like Patreon a lot more. I'm pushing things like merchandise and all that annoying crap. And then the adpocalypse happened. Yeah, the adpocalypse. Google Plus being removed and fucking the website infrastructure, all that kind of stuff. But I won't rant about it too much. I know people rant about it a lot nowadays, and I don't want to just be another whiner. But hey, at least Twitch is more fun. Twitch is significantly more fun, which I'm very glad about. Why the fuck are you lying? You're always lying. Oh my god, joke. What's the adpocalypse? The adpocalypse is a thing that happened a year, maybe even 2 years ago now. God, time goes so quickly. Essentially, the adpocalypse was when advertisers started complaining. Advertisers were complaining to YouTube, like, how dare you let this ad on my video, or how dare you post my advert or my product on this offensive video, oh my god. Which is a justified complaint, of course. You know, you don't want your product being associated with, say, a KKK rally on YouTube, you know. Of course, you don't want your things on that. But... when YouTube complied, they complied to such a horrendous degree with absolutely no consideration for the viewers or the content creators, only strictly the advertisers, that they introduced a bot, a very, very unfinished bot, which was automatically flagging people's videos, everyone's videos, so that they could not get advertisement revenue from it. That is crippling for big YouTubers and small YouTubers. It was crippling. And because of that, because a lot of the videos were not getting ad revenue, they weren't getting any earnings for not just YouTube, but for YouTube as well. It then meant that they weren't being highlighted, they weren't being pushed into feeds, they weren't appearing in people's subscription feeds, they weren't appearing at all. So YouTubers were not only seeing a decrease in earnings, but a decrease in views as well. Because at the end of the day, when it comes to YouTube, yes, views and clicks and everything are good, yes, of course, but everything comes down to ad revenue. And, you know, the more your video earns, the more it'll be promoted, the more it's promoted, the more it will earn, the more it will earn, the more it's promoted. It, you know, it goes in a circle. Which means that if you're missing a step, if it's not being promoted, or if it's not getting views and not getting earnings, it will just disappear. It will just completely disappear. And that was the adpocalypse. That was the beginning of it. And it fucked a lot of channels. That was when I first introduced Patreon. Because we were legitimately terrified that I was about to lose my job and had to go get, you know, quote-unquote, a real job. And people are still suffering now because YouTube are a pile of shit. People are definitely still suffering now because, like I said, Google+, yes, there was multiple waves, you're right. with Google Plus. So a lot of you may know Google Plus got cancelled recently or shut down or whatever. Google Plus was so heavily integrated, so heavily forced upon people at when it was first introduced. It was so integrated into the YouTube website that when Google Plus was officially shut down, YouTube itself went down for a couple of hours. I think it was a couple of hours anyway. The actual global YouTube website went down because they turned off Google Plus. Again, another thing that just completely screwed us over. Bearing in mind, I was a very happy person. I just was happy making content. So a lot of these things never affected me until it became important, like until I started relying on the revenue from YouTube. And then the bigger issues started happening. That's why nowadays I'm now very bitter and jaded. Because, you know, it sucks. Radical Larry, the whole Google Plus thing is like force feeding and then pumping our stomachs. Yeah, pretty much. A real job, I know what you mean, but this is a job as well. Oh, it is. It is. This is like I do the what I do as a job. In fact, in my opinion, as soon as you can start, you start getting charged for taxes. Let me rephrase that. As soon as you earn enough to pay taxes, that in my opinion is an official job. Happy to say I've reached that point. I may be wrong where to go, actually. It may not have been a couple of hours. I honestly can't remember. But the fact that it happened in the first place was very concerning. But I think the time the website was down, I was asleep. You know, time zones. I might be wrong, actually. A couple of hours does sound wrong. I mean, I tend to make shit posts, but I save them for when it's appropriate to use them. Yeah, exactly. I'm loving how this is looking so far, actually. But yeah, exactly. Like, I don't mind the odd shitpost as long as it's in context. I really don't mind that at all. It's when they're just, like, randomly just flung at you, like, hey, lol, I have this. Come look, lol, with no regards to the conversation. That's the kind of stuff I hate. Okay, that came out pretty well. I'm going now, so bye-bye. True Bright, I'll catch you later, dude, and as always, it was good to see you. And yeah, sorry if I ranted a bit there. I was trying to answer a question and I think I may have got a bit carried away, so I'm sorry. The first appealing choice YouTubers made in years was them playing the idea of making premium content free because it went against the point of YouTube. That'd be great. Well, actually, would it really? I never looked into premium content, so I don't really know what exactly that entails. That sounds like a great thing on the surface, but is it really, like, was it really doing any harm? I don't know. I'm just trying to get these different bits in the horn. It's actually quite complicated, this area. Why is it so hard to give feedback to you, Becca? Wait, what? Did I miss something? Sorry, did I miss something? YouTube Red. Yeah, I know YouTube Red is a thing. I never actually looked into it, so I don't actually know what it does. All I know, the only thing I know about YouTube Red is if you are a YouTube Red account watching my videos, I get more money. That's literally the only thing I know right now. And I need to make this horn or this bit way larger. I'm writing something right now. Oh, okay. I'm gonna be worried there, Ail. You asked about it earlier, so I'm doing it. Oh, the feedback. I gotcha, though. I gotcha. Right. Thank you, Ail. I completely just missed what you meant there. Thank you, dude. YouTuber cunts, though. Yeah, I've kind of been feeling that way lately. I've definitely been feeling that way lately. Which is annoying, to be honest. I used to be one of those people that would happily just, you know, side with YouTube regardless of what happened. But I just can't do that anymore. There's just too many very silly things happening. And we've always wanted to exit the app while the video is playing. I pretty butchered that wording there. Right. We've always wanted to exit the app while the video is playing. And then when they do enable it, they charge you for it. Wait, what? Really? Hold on. You can't exit the app with a video playing You can't do that anyway. And now you can. It costs. That just makes no sense. Wow. That is really fucking stupid. Surely that's like just an obvious thing to add as a developer. You can exit the app, but it stops the video playback. That's odd. It goes to show how much I use my phone. But Jesus Christ, that is just weird. Well, today I learned. So you can't play outside the app, unlike, say, Google Play. That's so dumb. Wow, okay. So yeah, like I was saying earlier, go Twitch. Yeah, today I learned. That's just really odd. Shit in it. Yeah, that really is shit. I have returned. Welcome back, Mara. Okay, those horns were very difficult to make, but I think we got there in the end. What I will do, actually, is just to quickly reduce the Dynamesh for a moment. Like, it's a nice lazy way of smoothing some of it, and then re-increase it again. There you go. You have the option to pop out the player for mobile. These days, I don't use my phone much. Sometimes for YouTube, I don't get calls often. I don't use my WhatsApp nearly as much on Discord. Yeah, same, actually. Nowadays, I only use my phone to make calls, obviously. I use my phone nowadays to make calls if I need to play solitaire if I'm on the toilet. So yeah, that's the one game I play, solitaire. Or to quickly say on Discord or on Twitter or whatever if I've DC'd during a stream. That's all I use my phone for nowadays. If I'm out and about, then I'll use it to upload a video. I really don't use my phone much at all. And yeah, I thought you guys might like that little bit of information there. Enjoy. It's just for you guys. It's just for you. Let's be honest, who doesn't play games on the phone when on the Twitch? Yeah, exactly. See, Sakasol, you know. You know Sakasol. Give me those horn models. You want this, sir? I can sort out for you if you want this. Some private details about Becca's life. Hey guys, do you want to know another private detail about my life? My hair is brown. There you go. That's another private detail. Now you know. Right. Okay, that is pretty much that bit done. I say you can have it as well, Becca. Alright then. Yeah, we can arrange that then, Sai. Right. There's one important thing I'm forgetting though, like one very, very important feature. YouTube does it because they can't show you ads because you aren't looking at the screen. Yeah, there is that. Right. That's not going to go well. Okay, I need to... Let's go ahead then. Am I okay with the overall proportions, actually? Let me just stop for a sec. Before I get any further in. Like, am I okay with the overall proportions? I guess this snout looks a little bit... blocky? Yeah, just a little bit. Yeah, okay. I'm going to quickly adjust a couple of things before I add that final piece. And I'm going to take this jumper off. One sec. So I am bloody hot. I'm also warm. Ha! Just kidding. Right. Mind blowing like pee-pee brown. Ale, mate, shut up. Thank you, my partner agrees to get me a new graphics card when we get paid. I'm going to take my PC to the shop to get it installed. Nice. Not going to be here for long, but I am back. Cam, still welcome back for the duration that you are here. It needs more neck, I guess. Compared to the bright picture, maybe. Right. So, first of all then, this entire bit here just needs to be, there you go, just a little bit rounder. That already made a massive difference right there. Let me see. This bit here can be a little bit flatter. Good. There's no thing there. Right, that's already better. Bottom jaw should be just a little bit smaller. Yep, good. Already looking good. I'm not sure how much I like those big jaws there. Actually, that kind of looks alright compared to the reference. Just make sure it looks good from every angle. Let's quickly go back to that. Bulkier horns. You hear that? Wait, you hear what now? Bulkier horns. I'll consider that in just a sec. Right, and just add a bit of thing that outside. I don't hear anything outside. Might just be the music. This music is very noisy, I guess you could say. Oh, you wanker. My PC's taking ages to load up again. Mara, man, what is up with your PC? Mara, have you got Windows Defender being a shit again? Check that. It may have been automatically switched back on. Right. For real though, I'm looking for more part ideas for the Dark Age community parts pack for Spore. Those will do nicely. Yeah, sorry, I'll happily sort this out for you then. Remind me again after the stream. I'll just chuck me a PM or something. That way I don't forget. And I will try and arrange it for you. Although I worry that might be a little bit too high definition right there. Or like high polygon. I might be able to sort that though. No, it's still switched off. Well, that kind of sucks. Sai, do an Amulite Shell. Do it, please. Sai, you have been told. Right, there you go. It's a little bit flatter. I'm really liking how this is coming out. It's looking awesome. A lot more, So I'm not going for realism here. But it is looking more realistic than I intended. I'm really liking that. Right, let's grab that toothy part there. Go ahead and just flip it. Actually, let's try that again. There you go, on the blue axes. Do that, activate symmetry, right then. And that there is basically all I want. Let's go ahead and dynamesh it. I don't want it to be a bit high res, actually. Just because it'll be a very thin part. Okay, good. The Benny scales are literal play, so I know once those are added in, it's going to make the neck look thicker. Alright, that's good to know then. That's good to know. And Kakadil, mate, I'll catch you later. As always, great seeing you as well. Look out, this reminded me that I need to work on Pikabar's commission. Maybe I'll record it. Nate, why not? In my opinion, I am of course biased here, you know, but if you have the ability to record something without it screwing your, without it messing with your computer or, you know, being a hindrance, I say why not? You can always delete the recording after if you don't like it. Where just somewhere I can look at all your artwork? Do I have a link for that? One sec. Twitch chat, do I actually have a link? Oi, links. That's the wrong link. Okay then. Yes, I have DeviantArt and I have ArtStation. One sec, dudes, one sec, that'll see. I forgot what that was. Right, let's grab that. And there you go as well. The ArtStation's a bit more professional. At least I'm trying to make it more professional. The DeviantArt I made when I was 15. So there's a lot of cringe there. I'm going to take my leave now. Thank you for streaming, Becca. Good afternoon. Banera, have a wonderful day, dude. It's always a pleasure to see you. And I'll catch you soon as well. Right. Got one major spiky there. Got another major spiky over here. Actually, that one needs to be a lot smaller, doesn't it? Yes. Go ahead, actually, just move over there for a sec. I have a lot of cringe on my DA as well. Yeah. It's always, it's the fun part, isn't it, about being young when you start doing things. Yeah, there's always that wonderful, awesome... what's the word? Damn, what's the word? Biggest of a C. Outcome? Conclusion? No. Result? I guess result works, actually. Our session is intimidating. Why do you find it intimidating? I'm actually quite curious about that space. Like, our station's got some really, really crazy good artists. Like, our station, in my opinion, in what I've seen, observation, looks like a very, very professional website. It looks nuts. I guess then, yeah, I can understand why you find it intimidating. But space, you could definitely post your stuff there. I think you could. There's no limit to what you can and can't post. There's no rules to my knowledge. It just, I've just noticed, you know, being very biased here, I've just noticed that our station has significantly less smut. It has a bit. But they're normally quite tasteful, actually. So yeah, it's where I'm posting a lot of my more finished things. Such as models. I cringe at things I've done a matter of weeks back. Those frills can go up or down as a kind of a warning type system, so don't worry about getting them too perfect. Ah, that's cool. Thank you, Manwolf. That's really cool. Yeah, that's the thing. The bar is set very high there. Okay, yeah. That's fair then. Mate, I'm loving how this is looking. I don't know why, but something about this just looks amazing to me. I think it's the mouth. Manwolf, thank you for having your birthday today. Right, now for the hard part. Actually, this shouldn't be too bad because it's flat. This should actually be quite fine. Go ahead and dynamesh it. Let's do that. I get real nice and thin. Okay then. I was going to make an art session, but I don't feel like I can draw enough. When you say draw enough, do you mean like you don't draw as often as you should, or you don't draw good enough? Because if you're worried about if you don't draw as often as you should, that definitely isn't a thing. Like, don't worry about that. Okay, I'm actually going to do this a different way, come to think of it. Let's just do that. Again, make it real flat. Okay. So first of all, let's go ahead and just grab all of that. Oh, that's a bit too high. Bollocks, sorry. That'll be fine. Right, let's cut all that off. The split's hidden. And I'll delete that segment there. Good. Move that lower. I mucked it up a little bit there. Right, good. Elderly Chinese man voice, Confucius says, artists who make great masterpiece to you later will only see horse shit. Well said. Well said. I don't think she should thank Mindwolf for that rather than her parents. Yes, yes, Mindwolf. Mindwolf's parents. Mindwolf's parents. Thank you for having Mindwolf today so that I can make this wonderful thing that I'm actually really enjoying. I have no idea why I did that way. Let's do that again. It actually goes up and down with our emotions as well, so the anger she gets go up, and when she gets sad, they go flat against her head, so like weird looking ears. That's cool though, I like that. I actually had a similar thing in mind for, I was going to say one of my characters, I remember. I actually had a similar thing in mind for the Jowie, Mindwolf. The Jowie's frills also animate in that particular fashion. Okay, that's not right. Try that again. Get us a bit better. I don't normally do frills this way, but because it is a flat image, it'll actually make it a lot much easier on me. Okay, that worked somehow. Nope, cancel. Don't delete that. I want to go ahead and split the hidden parts and delete that bit. There we go. And that there, for some reason, is there. Terrible. Did I again. I saw someone do this same thing in Blender recently, and or actually no, I saw someone do wings in Blender recently, like just very simple, large, flat surfaces. Oh my god, the difference between Blender and ZBrush for making wings is astronomical. Another reason why I need to learn Blender. It will just be superiorly easy there. Right, that's not too bad. That's actually pretty majestic. Do I see improvement? Wait, sorry. All those things, to be honest. I do know I'm still learning, of course. I do see improvement, but sometimes I'm just like, ugh. Oh, that's understandable, Mara. I think we all get that in some degree. I definitely get that. There's definitely times where I feel like, well, I'm making a pile of crap, such as yesterday. That cheetah yesterday that we made together, it looked horrible for the longest time, so I completely get what you're saying there, Mara. But at the same time, though, you also have good days where you're actually proud of what you make. Like, I'm actually quite proud of this right now. Although I may have mucked it up. Yeah, I mucked it up a little bit. Oh, I really mucked it up. Wow, okay. How did that happen? Thinking. Oh, I got a text. Oh, one sec, guys. Kev needs a hand of something. I'm gonna quickly do that and save it again. Right, while I do all this. Finally managed to log into ArtStation. Nice one. Stream stopped to buffer exactly as you released that cutout. Typical. I had like 13 tacos and they were delicious, but I feel so full. Yeah, 13 tacos, mate. I can't even have three. Right. Yeah. Need to quickly do something for Kev. I had to mute Muppets for a second, so a few minutes behind compared to my phone. Oh god. Do that, do that. Next. Now. There could be TV Tiny Tacos. That's true, actually. That's true. I know whenever I have burritos, more like, I know they're massive. Okay. And we back. I'll be heading off for now. I have to go visit Supermarket and buy some food myself. Okay, Shagari, if you're still here, of course. I'll see you later then. Hopefully see you later. Right. Back to this. I'm gonna try something here. It might go horribly wrong, but it's worth a shot. Mirror that. Manage that down. Symmetry. Right. If I do that, will they just automatically? No, they won't. Wow, I really did mess this up, didn't I? Okay. Let's just inflate everything. Not that much. Can I even inflate that? Hold on. No, I can't. Wow, I completely screwed up the fins. I've never seen this happen before. Alright, shit. How the heck does one eat 13 tacos by using their mouth? Jesus Christ. Mine will run around and warm myself up. That's a good idea. That should help. Yeah, I've completely managed to screw this up. It's just completely, gone too flat, essentially. Right. What if I... Can I use this? That might work, actually. If I inflate it like that. Dynamesh it, smooth it out. Okay, that works. So at least now it's not distorted. How bizarre. Right, well, now I know I can solve it that way. What did you do to Penya? I somehow managed to make some of the meshes so thin that they could not be increased. I really don't know how I managed to accomplish that one, but now I know, don't do it again. Kev! Right, mate. Right, mush. I replied to your text. Did y'all hear the first photo from Mars? Rover came in and found a Walmart up there. Jesus Christ. I actually haven't seen that yet. I need to check out the Rover. I'm normally all over that kind of stuff, but the time, I think the moment it was happening was when I was at the funeral. So didn't really get to see it, for rather fair reasoning. I need to watch a VOD for that. Wait, 10p hours? Wait, what now? I love this song so much. This song's amazing. Enjoy, friends. Right, pull that down as well. So yes, friends, like I said, I hate making these parts. Especially when they're not symmetrical. Or when they're not along the axis. Like, this is flat, so it's symmetrical, it's easy to do. But this is like dragon wings, for example, so there are different angles and sides and views. They are a nightmare. So I'm very glad I'm not making wings right now. Because they take... I think I've had wings take me like upwards of an hour alone. Which probably doesn't sound like very much, actually. But as you know, I'm fairly fast drawer. At least I think I am. Is the music gone? No, the music is just... The music starts out very silent in this song. He was talking in Dutch while you're right. Wait, what now? It's dead. The music isn't dead. It's just quiet. Okay, look, I'll turn it up for you. Because this music is so awesome, I'll turn it up for you. How about... There you go. Bit better, so go ahead and make it a little bit thinner now. And hopefully not have it spaz out again. I don't know if I realised now, but the now playing is under the reference image. Oh yeah, Mara, it's because the now playing is broken at the moment. So I've just completely hidden it. But thank you for telling me. Typical, yeah. Well, it's not broken. I'm wrong in saying it's broken. More like I'm not playing music on the other PC, so it can't track what I'm playing. Likewise, if I play music on the other PC like I normally do, I can't hear anything. It's a bit complicated to describe. Let's just say I need to fix my sound. We'll just say that. It does mess everything up, but I was pretty much a god at it back when it was a skill-based game instead of being a Swiss Army of Bots. Wait, what now? Oh, Robograph! I've not played that game in bloody ages. Well, it's great music, it's a little loud. Okay. See, I only turned it up because you guys were complaining that I turned the music off. It sounds like you're flying through space in an adventure. Mate, that's an awesome feeling to get from a song. Right. Right now, I'm just in the process of making all these just, point. Like that, for example. Good. Want to make that one significantly more exaggerated. Right, do that as well. As far as I can see in Mine Wolf's artwork, the sails here, or frills, whatever you want to call them, are actually very thin. Well, thin's the wrong word. They're not very broad. So I want to try and capture that. Of course, flatten it. There you go. Smooth it down. That's perfect. More like it. Same again over here. This needs to be much higher up. Created a private boss with sprinter legs, epic lasers, and a giant minigun on top of it. And double the energy module. You might check it out. Arcade died the moment they made it where you could put multiple types of guns on one bot. So then it became a matter of what bot could fit the most situations rather than what players can get the most out of the situations. Ah, that blows. Right, I get you. That kind of blows then. That's a bit of a rip then. The chill stream. Hello D, have a good day. I sure am so far. Thor, welcome mate, welcome. And yes, I am having a good day, thank you dude. I'm glad to hear that you are as well. It's a nice good old chill day, just chatting with friends. Drawing a dragon, as I always do. one of them good days, isn't it? Except when you're working on frills. Fuck these things. Right, there you go. That's more like it. Now then. If I want to be really anal with this, I could just do that. I've been using this a lot lately, and I'm really enjoying the way it works. Oh yeah, that makes a very nice, smooth finish. Like a little bit sharper, maybe. Not that sharp, actually. What if I reduce that? Cool, like that. Bear with me, guys. I'm a little bit silent, but I'm very much focusing on this. I will check the chat in just a uno momento. You know what I'm like when I get distracted. Or focus more like. Right. I quite like how that came out. Need to pull that back down a little bit though. So, oh, okay. There you go. GG. Just done like that. And let's make that bit there a little bit higher. The more bias towards the top. There you go. Same for that one. Bias towards the top. There you go. And smooth that down. That's horribly ugly. Right, good. Liking that. Oh, come back. No, not that one. Horns. And I just hit the mic again. I apologise. Right, yes, chat. Before that, it was on a decline, but it was at least forced players to build and play more strategically. Yeah, that's better. It's a lot better that way, isn't it? That's a bit of a shame to hear that it's just gone down that route. I still play occasionally, but it's more of an arcade mode where I build a cheesy sprinter back to chain minigun until shotgun to murder bug as many people as possible to 5v5, rather than my old favourite preferred role, being a heavy tanky gun bit in the good old not a part of the game anymore 8v8. Ah, that does sound a lot more fun though. It's actually what I did put it when they did it, but I can't find out checking out for like 4 hours, you get a model of the highest guns. Oh wow. VTOR's Michael here, where is Wyrm here? Snazzy, welcome mate, good to see you, good to see you. Membranes like that in general are a pain, yes. That's why I usually like the vertices and more standard poly modeling tools in Blender rather than just sculpting. Thor, that right there is the exact reason why I need to learn to use Blender. I have seen the standard, laying out the vertices to make the membranes. It is amazing, I need to learn it. It is that is the one thing I need more than anything else when it comes to making dragons. And Kaniki, good to see you. Welcome. Yeah, you've not been in a blah, blah, blah. You have not been here in ages. Kaniki, how are you? I got carried away there. Becca, slow down. Happens a lot, so I apologize. Right. Thinking. What do... I didn't realize ZBrush emailed you to trial. Well, yeah, how else are they going to give it to you? Right, I need to do that for a sec. Actually, wrong thing. If I do that... Okay, right now I'm just marking up a bit of a line. That way I can go ahead and mask that flap of skin there. Good. And pull that out so that way I can have the, I don't know what that's actually called, now that I think about it. A bit of gum that's just always there. That made no sense whatsoever. But I need to do a bit more of it, actually. Okay, there you go. Try that again, then. With better English this time. Grab that bit and move it down. There you go. But now I've done it too far. It's fine, though. I can just easily fix that. And then pull all that back. What do you call this part of the mouth anyway? I actually don't know. I've got no idea. So what are you making here? I get the idea it's a Norse symbol because of the serpent designs on the horns and the Norse symbol in the bottom of the corner. Yes, like Mara said, I'm making Mildred's characters. Mildred's birthday today. And me being the brilliant friend that I am, completely forgot. I know mine morph, that there were reasons for it. But I've just decided, screw it, I'm gonna make mine morph her very own character, or her own sculpt. She deserves it. Despite what she says, she deserves, you know, nice things. Okay, that's actually a bit of a weird angle. Let's go ahead and just adjust that. I've no idea how to paint the ZBrush, I'm a mess. Space. You use core, right? Use core the same as I do. If you want to paint, you see these three buttons, or there's five buttons up here. MRGB, RGB, M, Z-add, and Z-sub. All of those basically are the different modes, if you will. Z-add and Z-sub is sculpting. So when you add more on top. When you sub, you subtract from it. So you dig into it. The M stands for material, so you change the actual material itself. And the RGB is how you paint. So that's like your RGB colors, red, green, and blue. So if you want to paint, like go into standard or whatever, select RGB, unselect your add or your sub, and then you just paint on like that. MRGB, I've never actually used, so I don't know. I'm assuming that one's material RGB, but again, never used it, don't know. So that should hopefully help. And JessieFlora25, thank you for the follow and welcome. Okay, that's a bit better. It's another nice song, actually. I've really been enjoying the chill songs lately. But yeah, definitely liking how that's coming out. I'm kind of reaching a bit of a point now. I'm reaching the point of this, whereas either I polish it and make it a nice simple bust or portrait, or I start working on scales and make it a more complex one. I kind of want to do both, actually. I kind of want to make two different versions of this. Because again, it's pretty much like a not quite a free commission, but kind of a free commission, so I would like the examples as well, to have like a detailed one and a simple one. Just adding texture, by the way. I don't like that the horns are completely flat and smooth. I'm just adding like a bit of noise. I'm doing great, thank you, but I don't have time to work because I don't have my money. Oh no, Kaniki! Now focus on exams and final tests in informatic, English and math. Oh wow, well good luck though. That's awesome that you're It sucks to hear that you're not working anymore, but I do hope that the exams go very, very well. I really hope so. What changes in my life? Life has been a bit shit lately, but I don't want to keep talking about it on stream. So just at the very, very least, I'll say in the last 2 weeks I've been scammed and I went to a funeral for a relative. Life is okay. It's just kind of bit me in the ass recently, but otherwise things are good. Things are good. As good as can be. But as for a change in life, well, I'm soon opening up to commissions, so I guess that kind of counts, doesn't it? Finally. I've been promising commissions for a bloody year now. I'm finally getting there. I hope it'll be great as much as it can. Thank you. And likewise, I do hope that the exams go well. Right, yeah, I'm kind of just procrastinating at this point now. How do I want to continue this? Am I missing any features? No, I've got pretty much every feature. Oh, the plates. The belly plates. I forgot about that. Chest plates. Because it's awesome mind morph, what is it anyway? Is it a dragon or a serpent? It's a dragon. I hope the best for you. Thank you, Space. Thank you. I've literally only got 5 things in my art station. I've got so much more to upload. Mate, do it. Do it. It'd be awesome to see what you can do. I use MRGB and I can't change the material now. Change the colour and material. Oh, fair enough. Just pop in and say hi. Hey, nice dragon head. At least I believe it's a dragon. Never know with draconics these days. Indeed. Indeed. But Reaper, good to see you, mate, and welcome. It's Upwork. Is that a... Are you trying to... It's Upwork. Is that a variant of What's Up, Doc? Are you trying to get me again? Mate. Cheeky sod. What song is playing in your background? The song right now is... Oh, it's a bit loud. I'm sorry. I forgot to turn it down. There you go. The song right now is The Seventh Summer by Sirenia. Or Sirenia. I'm not sure how you pronounce it. The Seventh Summer. That was too many S's for me to pronounce. Right. Actually, I'm going to do this a smart way. Screw that piece. Let's do this the smart way. If I go ahead then and just mask... Oh, not like that. Mask all of that for a sec. I was liking the music. I could hear you easily enough. Oh, I'm sorry. Do you want me to turn it back up? I should put it down to the same volume as I had yesterday because I know people yesterday said it was a little bit loud. A nice art session. I've got 5 things in art session. I need to upload more. Yeah, mate. Like I said, do so. In my opinion, like, other than time, other than that, what have you got to lose? Turn a little bit higher. There you go, bud. Hope that's better. Hopefully you're all good with that. Then again, music volume per song varied. Dummy too. Oh, yeah, true. That's very true, isn't it? Right. How do I do this again? I think it's extract, right? I don't do this very often. Yep, perfect. Except. Okay, good. And now I've got the speed here, which I can now use as the plate. So let's go ahead then. First things first, is smoothen all that up. And we're actually going to make it a bit more low res as well. For our benefits and convenience. Oh, wait, what's the name of the song, song itself? I got the name of the band, but the song. The name of the band, sorry, the name of the song is The Seventh... Wait. The Seventh Summer. I really should do something about this playlist, shouldn't I? People are a lot more interested in it than I expected. I actually tried doing a Dino Dinosaur Beast. Doing a Dino Dinosaur Beast, that'd be cool. How did that go? I like doing dragons, mainly because they're very relaxed, you know, there's no like right or wrong way to make a dragon. Which is technically kind of lazy in a way, but for me it's a lot more relaxed. I really do want to do some dance also. I'm just very, very, what's the word, apprehensive, because, you know, if you do it wrong, you know, how dare you? I've gotten burned by making dinosaurs wrong a lot in school. I'm a bit scared to do it on, in ZBrush. But at the same time though, I think it'd be awesome. I have a little free time. I didn't watch the last episode of The Walking Dead. Sorry, Becca. I'll be later if you're still here. Have a good night. If not, see ya. Kaneki, mate, enjoy yourself. No problem at all. Just enjoy yourself. I'll see you later. As always, it's good to see you. Yes. Yeah, exactly, Sagato. Exactly. Like, I get it bad enough in sport. When I'm not going for realism or accuracy, I just, like, if I just want to make a Rex, I just want to make a Rex. So, the idea of making a Rex wrong in, like, in actual 3D software is a little bit intimidating, actually. I'm sure that link will work. No, you can't... Oh, let me just turn that music down a sec. Yes, no links, I'm afraid. PMA moderator. Is there any moderators on, actually? Oh no, okay. PM it to me, dude, and I'll post it for you. Yeah, normally PM it to a moderator and I'll post it for you, but I think they're all gone at the moment. Which is fine. Oh, Ale! No, Ale's there! Okay, bombard Ale with your link. Link it to him 5 times, at least. Ale, mate! It's not my fault you did the same thing in the last 5 minutes. Hey, by the way, guys, do you remember, I'm professional. Calm down, Ale. Right, let's go ahead then. A bit there. actually, just to make my life really easy, I am going to go ahead and just reduce all of that. Because I'm thinking about it too much and it's annoying. That's better. So now I've got more room to muck around with. Okay, good. So now I can move that entire thing just in slightly and not worry quite as much. I'm going to go to try and create things in Sephora again. Good luck on stream and see ya. Others may have a wonderful day. And good luck, I look forward to seeing it. Ale is Alispil. The red dude in the chat with the sword in his name. On the ground crying, that's where he is. Mate, Ale, like I said, it's not my fault, dude, that you didn't speak for a whole couple minutes. I danced to Epica. No, Snazzy. I've never actually heard that before. Which reminds me, I need to check out that song you posted yesterday. I saw you posted it, but I hadn't watched it yet, so I need to check that out. Oh, whoops. Okay, that's looking alright. Let's go ahead then. That's my fault. I was admiring his creations. Wow, Bizzle. I can't believe you... Bizzle! How dare you admire someone else's work? Like, mate, this stream is obviously about my work. Like, God. Fuck! Wow, that sounded a bit native, didn't it? Hello, Dragon Chick. Welcome! How are you doing today? As I'm just sarcastically yelling at someone. How you doing? I'm off to play some more Dark Souls 3 before I roll dice in my Legend of Zelda game. Have a good one, Becca and chat. I'll see you a lot later. Take care and stay safe. Reaper, thank you very much, dude. As always, good seeing you, and I'll see you later as well. Have fun! Have fun, man. That sounds cool. You got a request? Well, I may or may not have a reply. That doesn't really work, does it? It's a pretty good band. I recommend the Quantum Enigma and Create Your Universe. Both are amazing albums by Epica. Ah, alright then. I'll have to check it out. How long have I been using ZBrush for? It looks amazing. Thank you, Larry. How long have I been using ZBrush for? Oh, that's a good question, actually. How long have I been streaming for? A year? 2 years? It's been 2 years now, right? Or has it been 1 year? I've been using ZBrush for however long I've been streaming. I actually had ZBrush gifted to me very early when I began streaming. I think it's been 2 years. And Draki! I tried out something new on the Ducky Big Bites commission and oh my god, I love it. Good. Fantastic. Oh, what just happened there? Somehow went to the wrong thing there. Right, how's that looking overall? That's looking a bit awkward, actually. This bit here is significantly just wrong. I posted comp prices anywhere. A man might be interested. Hmm. Maybe today or later. Can you sculpt the Valiled creature? It could be interesting in your style. No, if I'm going to be honest. I rarely do requests anyway, because requests, you know, I can't say yes to one person, no to the other. I absolutely will not do ZBrush requests, because they take tremendously longer. Spore, you know, I might be a little bit cheeky every now and then, but ZBrush, I'm gonna just have to say no. I'm open to any ideas. I'm open to ideas, but I'll never say yes, I'll do your request, unless it's a commission. Sorry, Dragon Chick, I need to be fair. But... if that's the thing that you told me about yesterday, that was a really cool concept. Oh god. Camera spin. Right, it's Spore can count though. Let's see, was that the thing that you told me about yesterday? The Valiles. Mr. Cookies check. Was it in Spore? Was it that thing? No, that's something else entirely. Okay. Let's quickly look it up then. What was it again? It's a kind of like my own personal Jowie. Oh! Oh, right. Right, okay, okay. That's cool, by the way. But okay, so if it's like an original character, then yeah, it'll be. I probably will not be able to do that. Again, unless it's like a patron or whatever. Again, you know, gotta keep it fair, which bloody sucks. Actually, what you can do is the next time I start remaking other people's creations, I do that every now and then, you're absolutely more than welcome to post it then. I absolutely feel free then. That's like my official, yeah, I'll make your stuff moment. I gave some feedback. Ale, mate, thank you. I really want to look at it. But I'm doing this, I really need to see it. But thank you, I actually really appreciate it, man, thank you. Whatever it is you've written. Watch it be really trolling, and I said thank you. Though I'm crap at this. Hey, no, there's no case of being crap or not. Every time I get comfortable, my damn body starts to be awkward. Mate, I know that feel. Right now I'm just kind of making the armored bits actually look like armor. Or bony parts, you know what I mean. In fact, I'm forgetting my amazing new favourite tool, clay polish. And that right there has already made a big difference in just making it more angular. Bear with me as I try to figure out the settings I want for this. If I go ahead then and just smoothen all of that, actually that's the wrong thing entirely. Alright, so just smooth all that out. Smooth all of that out. And all of that out. Good, have like another little divot. Come on. There. Okay, good, excellent. And then now if I use the clay polish, it'll be a little bit more. Yeah, okay, I quite like how that came out. It's not perfect, but we're making progress. You still inspire me to make great creations. Mate, thank you. I'm really glad about that. Thank you, Dragon Chick. That's awesome, dude. That really is. Thank you. I have a draconic OC of my own, well technically two in one, as two characters have been fused into one. Her name is Harmonia, which is inspired by this, but it's one The Legend of Spyro webcomic I've been reading. Wow. That sounds pretty sick, dude. Did you get the link? No, I don't think so. Not that I can see. What's going on? I'm not sure. Ale, did you get a PM by any chance for the link? I sent it to Ale. Ale! Mate! I think he may have been busy. And thanks for another sketch of him yet. Maya, look forward to seeing it if you do a sketch. You didn't get anything. Ale! Yeah, see? Like, he knows, man. He knows. Fucking Ale! You don't smile. Jesus. Glass! Lovely to see you. Welcome. Save me from this madness. Alright, that's fine, dude. If Ale didn't receive it, feel free to PM it to me instead, and I'll try. Bloody links and bots and blah blah blah. I heard that as a fucking a-hole. Mate, maybe that's what I said. Right. I mean, what now? Nanny? Okay. Add the horns back in. And that is looking pretty cool. I like this. You inspired me since I was like, I don't know, 11 years old. Oh my god. Yeah. Space, that reminds me. I was actually talking about that with Kev just recently. How some of the people in his chat, some of you guys, like, what was it? It was either Glass or Loki. One of them two were the ones who used to watch me from when they were a child. Several years ago, and now look at us, you know, we're all happy playing Ark together, you know, being good friends and such. And the weirdest thing about that isn't the fact that people started watching when they were young, or when, no, actually, let me rephrase that. It's a really strange, unique feeling, okay? It's a really, really bizarre feeling knowing that some of the people I have friends right now, I get along with really well and such, are people who 10 years ago, when I was still a teenager, they were an infant. That's a really bizarre, but yet a very, very cool feeling. And I finally got the link. We got the link, guys. Oh, wait. Oh, shit. Did I just see that right? Oh, man, that's cool. There you go. Oh, that's really cool. I like that. Oh, wow. Your elite cyborg is awesome, dude. In fact, all your humanoids are awesome. That's really cool. Okay, followed. That is awesome, man. Thank you for showing me. What if spores spawn to an early tribe in the creature stage that vanishes? An early tribe in the creature stage that vanishes? Or if there's caves in spore? Oh, you're throwing ideas! That'd be awesome. I'd love that. It's really low res because that was the only image I could find. Oh, fair enough. That's really cool though. One sec, just having a stretch. Glass, happy to hear that she's good. Right. Don't mind me as I just stare at this model for a moment. And Kev! Mate, 18 months. Fucking hell. So that goes to show then, I think I have been streaming for 2 years then, not one. So that's how long I've been playing ZBrush. Playing ZBrush? No, learning ZBrush for is 2 years then. But goddamn, Kev, thank you for the 18 month resub, dude. Hype, hype. Maybe like a short stage, like a micro stage, that'd be awesome. And welcome back, Shagaru. Welcome back, dude. What time is it? It's nearly 6. Don't mind me as I just think about what to do next. Alright, there's only one thing I can do next. More details. Hello, Santa Sonic. Welcome, dude. Welcome. Right, well, first of all, as always, I start with the eyes. Because I... Actually, nah, fuck the eyes. Just go straight into the body. And Glass, BOB a hot moment, get some tea and move to a laptop. As always, 100 bits for the good luck and while I'm gone. Thank you, Glass, for the 100 bits. And Sandal Sonic, thank you for the follow. God damn. Right. Let's go ahead then and just a Dynamesh. Let's just quickly save because I always crash this point. Resolution. Did it not crash once? Wow, that's a first. Okay. Now, how am I going to do the scales on this? So, how? Oh god, goddamn it, there you go. Let's try that. I like these ones. Thinking. I could do like that. While I imagine Kev's that thing after saying high five. Fun fact, balls were just supposed to have a stage prior to starting school of Molecular Stage. I remember that. Speaking of OCs, I'm really starting to develop Gem. Like she's a third dragon, not scared one, because of her more rabbit shape. Ooh, that'd be a really cool Gem. Yeah, do work more on that. That'd be cool. Right. Fuck. I'm trying to think of how best to do this. Bear with me as I forget how to draw. How do I want to do this actually? How do I do my Jowie? Give me a sec, guys. I'm just gonna stop for a moment. No, not that one. Where's my good one? There. I just realized I can sculpt my mechs. Oh, Maron, nice. Okay, that's still loading. Oh, while it's loading. Okay, there you go. Right, so this is one I've done before. So how do I do the face on this then? Well, I need gum. That's definitely a thing. I need to do the gum somehow. I can do that quite easily. That's fine. Otherwise... Okay. My creature should be here by the end of the day. Draki! PogChamp! Computer hype! Okay, back to recording. I'm not going to do it quite like I did the realistic Jowie, but I am going to go like a little bit ham on this, I reckon. It won't be perfect. It is, after all, fantasy creature. But I will go a little bit ham. Just a little bit. Right, so first of all, let's just make all this here rough. Wait, what do you think I said? I need gum, not I need gum. Wait, I didn't even say I need gum. I may have been speaking too quickly again, I'm sorry. I'm really trying to kick that habit, and it is so, so easy to forget. Okay. Do that, blur it all out. And then grab that one there, and let's just go a little bit ham. Not that ham. It's probably pretty interesting if only there's more. Yes, I entirely agree. Like, Spore had a lot of missed potential, it really did. It's a fun game, for sure. But the fun, you know, it only lasts so long, doesn't it? It would be awesome if there were just more to the game. The last 1% of intervention always takes so long. Yeah, it does. Okay, so that's a bit of a rough thing, if you will. Let's do the same thing on the bottom drawer as well, keep it consistent. Have you ever considered recreating a dance with some Jurassic World Evolution, or would it be the same as just creating any other dance with sparking the feather debate? Yes, I have thought about it. You are right. It probably would create the same debate. Regardless of that, though, I would love to do it. I'm just intimidated by it. I don't really feel ready to attempt something like that yet, but I am really keen on doing just dances in general, not just Jurassic World, but dances anyway. Yeah, it's been a funny one. I don't feel ready, but then again, I'm not going to know if I'm ready until I do it. You know, it's one of those things, isn't it? Why does the song sound like Chop Suey? Because it's from the same brand. Yeah. Brand? Band? Yeah, it's by the same artist or band. I can't speak. Right, there we go. And then grab that picture there. I've created the spinner raptor myself and it was really enjoyable. Good. Yeah, I've been meaning to make that actually. I do still to make the spinner raptor and the stegoceratops. Is that alright? Stegoceratops? I started to make those in Spore, let alone ZBrush. But I definitely do want to. Oh, wrong thing. Okay, we probably shouldn't have this song on. Probably not the best one to have on. As much as I love that song. It's a bit, yeah. Harmonious are fur dragons as well, but that's because of the other two fused gunherd, Spectre and Penumbria. Penumbria. Also fur dragons, Spectre's fur pure white. The theme of them is their sisters whose elements or personalities are opposite, opposites, Spectre being a light one. That's really cool, Snazzy. That's awesome, dude. I think it may have been a cut out at the end there, but it's still very cool regardless. Sorry for the wall of sex, that's fine, dude. Yeah, no problem at all, but that's cool. Wow, how am I... I normally crash by now. I'm actually quite surprised I haven't. Okay, let's go ahead then and let's just do myself a bit of a favour here. Actually, no. When I think about it, I'm gonna go ahead and let me just go ahead make Polymesh 3D, go back to the previous one. There you go. I want to append that back in, so now I should have two of them. Did that screw anything up? No, good. Right, let's delete the original one. I also want to append that, so Pointless Rudy is another reason why I'd love to have the full version. I don't think I have to do this. The original. So now all I can do is just very, very simply merge those two together. Excellent. Bit of a roundabout way of doing it, but it works. Damn it, that's a crush. Come on, crash already. This is the best bird I've ever colored. That's good, Draki. That's what inspired me to write more lore on my left rafters. Building an arc takes so damn long, it really does. System of a Down being a brand is a funny thing. Damn it, ZBrush, I'm getting angsty waiting for it. I'm so happy my sculpture came out. Thank you for suggesting sculpture, Becca. No, face, no problem, dude. I saw it, it looked amazing. I'm really glad that you did. Oh, wrong thing. Neat. Hello, Jermaine. Welcome, dude. Right, that was not the one. Let me see. Is it a quick save? There we go. Great. Back over here then, before it crashed. Did I do what I wanted in the end? Yes, I did. Okay, so I just need to try and Dynamesh it again. Preferably without it crashing this time. Let's try 340. Okay, good. 440. I'm expecting this, by the way. I'm expecting this to happen. I'm just trying to push how far I can do it. Share it on Discord so we can hog real hard at it. Space already did. I remember seeing him post on Discord last night, and it looks really, really cool, like I said. Right, try that again. The geometry, Dynamesh. We'll just leave it 440. It's good enough. It doesn't have to be too high. Right then, so back to what I was doing then. Let's go ahead and grab that one there. Our goal is finally done. Mara! Hype, hype. Right, first things first is, actually, before I do anything else, I do want to go ahead and merge these a bit better. Right now, they're looking very slapped on. Okay, good. Oh, come on, piss off. I'm still wondering how to write the law of Harmonia. The events leading up to Spectrum and Penumbra fusing to Harmonia are tragic to say the least, but both have found how to live their new life in one body. I'll just say this, that's way out of my creativity. I've not been able to think creative like that in a long time. Whatever you can come up with, dude, I really look forward to seeing it, if you do end up writing it. Right. Try again over here then, shall we? No, my PC just took its time. Mara. Okay, good, finally, no longer crashing. And down there as well, make that look smoother. What brush are you using for scales? I use a combination of brushes. Bear with me one moment. So I mainly use the standard brush, and the alphas I use are typically either... I'll use this one for the very large ones, let me demonstrate. That one for the much larger scales, like the more rocky, rough areas. A combination of these snake-like ones. Like that one as well, I'll be using that one shortly. And then I might just mishmash a bunch of these other ones in. I kind of overlap a lot of different alphas and just try to merge them together and create an effect or whatever. The way I draw is very messy. And I just tend to just layer over and over and over until I'm satisfied. And Snazzy, no problem, dude, no problem at all. I basically said I don't have the creativity for that. I just look forward to what you come up with if you do write it. Nito didn't know they were alphas or if they were a brush. Oh yeah, yeah, they're via alphas. is probably not the right way to do it. I'm not actually sure. But it's just a bit of a thing that I've got going so far that, you know, that I quite like. So right now, for instance, now I'm going to just start dashing in random specks of small scales here and there. Actually, no, I'm not, because I don't like the resolution. It's too low. I'm going to go ahead and divide it. And now I'm going to do that. So yeah, so I tend to go for something very, very messy looking, because in general, you know, nature is not neat by default. Some parts are neat, of course. But I personally just feel like it's a lot more relaxing just to do it like a bit messier. You kind of like that, for example, change to another nude one. Like, let's try this. How will that come out? That's a bit, it's a bit harsh, but that'll be good for certain areas. What if I try this one? That'd be good. The stream inspired me to start up Blender. Nice. Mate, good. This sounds like System of a Down. It does. I swear the majority of the music today has just been System of a Down, hasn't it? Right, I'm actually going to turn down the intensity on that one because it's getting a little bit rough. There we go, that's better. You're rigging a Baryonyx model I made at the moment. Oh, nice. That's awesome, dude. Another thing worth noting, now when I, you know, of course, like I said, I do this very messily. When I do end up doing textures and such, a lot of the mess will be a bit harder to notice. And it just creates like a bit of a, not rainbow per se, but like a whole multitude of colours and levels and all that kind of stuff. And like I said, it's just a little, it's just my style I've kind of picked up over time, and I like it so far. I'm still learning. I'm definitely still learning. But it's just what is, you know, kind of working for me so far. Yo, those people who sound like System of a Down. Hell yeah, Mastercraft, Rattled on Saddle and Arc. Oh, nice one, Bizzle. Sweet dude, grats. Let's go ahead then and just do all of that. Dungeons of the Screenshots and Arc in general. Wicked. Looking forward to seeing that. I should say the internet support me playing Arc. It supported the stream well enough yesterday. Ooh, blast, about damn time. Only 314 frames dropped during the stream the other day, which is better than I expected. That's not too bad, actually. Not too bad at all. Yeah, hopefully it goes better. Oh, wow, you're already overwhelmed? Yes. ZBrush has that effect, doesn't it? It is quite overwhelming at the start. Right, quick set, guys. I need to put out a video for today. What is today's video going to be? Arc, of course. Could you make a clip and scroll back? Wait, what now? Oh, is there any way to skip to a previous point in the stream? Ah, yes, yes. You can. You can do just that glass. One sec, guys. Today's video. I'll just move the microphone for a sec. Put that on Discord. Is that the right link? Yeah, it was. Thank God. See public. Put it in the arc thing. There you go. Good. Okay. And back over here. Right then. Back to scales. Do a little bit over there. Again, just pretty rough, to be honest. If it wants to do anything, come on. There you go. It won't let me. Could you message your response to me on Discord when you're done with the stream, Becca? Yeah. Should not be a problem. Right. Again, just adding a little bit more weight to certain areas. There you go. Kind of feeling like I may I need to adjust one thing, and that is I just realized just how bulbous the back of the head is. So I do need to kind of fix that to make it look a little bit more natural. Bit of a very amateur way of doing it, but hey, it's easy and cool. And I'm a bit lazy right now. Just do that there. Just pull that out, make it flow as well. Okay, that's a bit better. And then go ahead and just reapply some of those. Yep, that right there, just did it automatically, GG. And there you go, kind of broke that apart a bit. Good. Hello guys, I am back. Welcome back to Kakadel. And Discord's basically like a combination between Skype, TeamSpeak, a website forum, all those kind of things. It's basically like a server that we can all talk on, whether it's writing or in voice. Also allows you to post links, images and such. Discord is a deity of chaos and mayhem from My Little Pony, that too. And Wedigo, mate, thank you very much, dude. Thank you for the help earlier. And I hope you enjoyed it. I'll hopefully see you later. I'm gonna get some food and settle down for the evening. Sounds good. I might actually do the same. Yeah, 6. I will be heading off very soon, actually. Good call. So this program's Blender. No, I'm using ZBrush. I am too much of a scrub to learn Blender. One day I'll learn it. Oh, that was the wrong file. No. Where is it? Pena? There you go. Is ZBrush worth getting? I mean, to 3D. It depends on what your goal is. If you want to animate and rig and all that kind of stuff, it is good, but definitely not the best because you need to do retopology and, you know, rework the polygons. If you want it just for concept, just for drawing, just for having fun, making super detailed stuff, but not actually rigging them, in my opinion, yes, it is worth getting. There is Sculptress, which is like, Sculptress is free and it's like a nice smaller thing to get you into 3D modeling. Or you can get the ZBrush trial, which is 45 days, and you can experience the entire thing. Make models, create game characters, and 3D printer. Yeah, that's pretty much, yeah. In that case, I think ZBrush would be good for it. For the printing part, but for the game characters, if you want to rig it and animate it, you will want to learn Blender as well. Is there a way to take some HD screenshots from ZBrush Sculpt to mine a Leica 9500? That sucks. I don't actually know. For me, I just export it. If I go into like document, export. Range, border. I've actually not played with these, huh? Great. I have to look into that space. I actually don't know. I'd love to get ZBrush to make my D&D characters I created. That'd be awesome, dude. It is. For someone like me who's a hobbyist, this is lovely just for getting ideas out and, you know, bring them to life. It definitely is great for that. The normal ZBrush is $895, which is a ton. ZBrush Core is $180, which sells a little too much in my opinion. Yeah, it is expensive. I do agree with you. I do agree. It is a very pricey bit of software. Yeah, I guess it depends on your individual financial things. For me, it was too much. I only have it because it was gifted to me. But I can understand how for some people, like, 150 is too much. like how it's just a very overall smooth kind of thing. It's a bit of a weird obsession of mine. I just like things being messy. I just noticed that I was poking through it. Let's get rid of that. Good job. All good stuff. The back of the throat there as well, actually, is protruding through. So, what am I going to do with that, actually? Thinking. That works. There we go, just kind of like creating a throat for it. There we go, that works. Good. I got carried away there. I'm learning better at the moment. It's not hard to learn IMO, just remembering what the shortcut keys are. It's a pain for me, I agree. With UE4, you need to import characters into it. I see. What you need is for Unreal game development knowledge, is knowledge and an NVIDIA graphics card. Hell yeah, I have one of those things. Yeah, like I said, I don't think Blender actually is that hard to use. I personally just really, really struggle with it. So I may be giving it more flack than I should. But I stand by it though. I stand by it. It is definitely, like, whether or not you have a hard time or a good time learning it, you should still at least try. If you're into like modeling, 3D, game design, animation, any of those things, you should definitely look into it. Because it's free. Like, it's completely free. So why not? Unless you lack time, why not? Oh, that's an amazing texture for horns. I've never used that before. Okay, that looks pretty good, actually. So I'll go ahead and move that. Is this Lordy? I think so, actually. Who is this? I mean the music, yeah. Yes, this is Lordy. It's not illegal for people to have free copies of SAI since they're basically getting around the use of the license file because it's an old program because they're not too worried about it and they fix the issue. Oh, I see. Right. Okay, Gloss. I need to message you after. I have inquiries and questions I'd like to know. Right. Yeah, I'm quite liking this actually as a thing for the horns. As long as I kind of blur it every now and then. I'd rather stick to my little drawings. Programming's hard. Mate, that's fair. That's how I'm feeling at the moment. Like, I want to do all these things, like rigging and such. I want to do that. But for now, I'm happy just drawing. But it's definitely a goal for the future. That's for absolute sure. Right, go ahead and blur those out so I'm not quite... Oh, what a time to save. Make that a little bit there. I wish I could draw, try to get into it recently, but it's just a mess. And bear in mind that everyone starts somewhere. I guess that's another thing as well, actually, like, while I'm sitting here talking about 3D and such. It also depends on if it's actually a thing for you. Like, I don't know why. I really felt like I just clicked 3D weirdly quickly. Like, when I first using sculptures and such, I just got the hang of it. It just felt natural. And I know a lot of people won't necessarily feel that. Some people will feel more natural towards 2D. Or hell, maybe even live, like, real sculpting, like, with a bit of clay. Like, hell, even that might be better. So if you don't feel good with like one style of art, maybe try another. Like nowadays, I used to be very confident in 2D. I'm not anymore. I actually feel more confident 3D than I do 2D. I've no idea why. It just feels better and I can get things done a lot faster. You missed a message again. Here in Israel, we have a holiday really soon, so I can use that time to study modeling, game and design. My birthday is December 11th, though. So the second thing is that the holiday ends on the 9th. Right, I see. So the holiday ends just before your birthday. That does kind of blow. But it's good to hear, though, that you've got the opportunity to learn. As for the link of ZBrush and Blender mixed project, only took 5 hours, but I wanted better lighting and whatnot. One sec. Oh, wow. I'm gonna link that so other guys, so other people in the chat can see it. That's cool, dude. That's really cool. Yeah, the general atmosphere in that is awesome. Another reason why I need to learn Blender. Oh, I like the hard objects scope. Oh, wow, that's really cool, actually. I like that a lot. Right. Should have spent more time drawing than building robots when I was younger, to be honest. I mean, Zenith, you say that, and yet look at how much time I've spent in school. You and I are not so different. I've spent a lot of time building in school. So, you never know me. Like I said, there's no harm in trying. Or trying different things, mainly. But, definitely don't feel like your time was a waste. Like, at the end of the day, time had fun. Is it really time wasted at all if you had fun? And of course, I did the same thing. Spent all my time playing sport. Instead of, in fact, that's the thing. Like I said, I used to be very confident in 2D, mainly hand-drawn art, but like a bit on digital as well. Then I got Spore. And then eventually I played WoW. And ever since I played WoW, I just stopped drawing entirely. I only picked it back up about 3 years ago, actually. I've only started drawing again 3 years ago. That's it. So you never know what you might be able to accomplish. Please create an artist game based on the Jammy Wars. Mate, that'd be well cool. That'd be really cool, actually. One sec, guys. I'm sorry, I'm hearing noises. Give me a sec. Oh, bloody cables, get off! Okay, I'm sorry. Sorry about that. I heard noises in the other room, so I had to check it out. Which would you recommend buying, the 140 version or the 900 pounds for a beginner? For a beginner, I'd definitely recommend the cheaper version, just because it's more digestible and you can always upgrade it later. You can upgrade it to the bigger version later. Otherwise, I'd actually say, before you spend any money, try the trial version first. The 45-day trial for ZBrush is the full product. 45 days, plenty of time to figure things out. And if you decide you actually want the product, then buy it. That's my personal advice. One nice thing that came out of Roblox is that it gave me a head start in coding. I would have more problems getting my head around it now if I didn't play Roblox. I actually felt like I'm the same way, Zenith, when it came to Spore. Because I spent so much time in Spore, I was always making 3D, I was always looking at anatomy, looking at proportions, all that kind of stuff. I honestly think that helped me in 3D as well. It didn't help the actual process, but it helped, you know, me having an eye for it. And me making sure things were all okay. And Santa, no problem, dude, no problem at all. You're welcome. Only 3 hours, pretty much, yeah. Only 3 hours on this. Right. Well, I have a bit of a emphasis around up here. And I'm using the wrong part, cool. Right, I'll do that. And that way it doesn't just look quite as slapped on, it looks like it's actually embedded in the horn. It's a very subtle sort of thing. But yeah, I guess when it comes to commissions and such, this right here, considering I'm chatting and stopping and looking at things and such as well, I feel like this here is a good example of the fact that I actually can draw quite quickly. What's funny though is that it'll probably take me longer to do a simple polished one than it would something like this. This is quite amusing, really. Saying that, doing the tattoos on the horns will be absolutely terrifying. I am not looking forward to that at all. Those tattoos are going to be the end of me. You should finish your commission. Mate, finish it. Finish it so that you can have more fun doing other things. Unless you enjoy it, of course. Then do it anyway. I did the laundry 2 hours ago. Mate. Just saying that, it's nearly 6:30. I really should stop soon. I don't wanna, but I should. Kev will be home soon, I gotta prepare dinner. And Penya needs a tongue. She actually does not have a tongue. So that needs to be sorted out as well. Speaking of missions, I need to sketch up that $200 commission. But that $200, bloody hell, Glass. Bloody sick. Oh wait, did you get a new one actually? Or was that the one from yesterday? Either way, that is awesome. That is really, really nice. I was going to paint my dragon sculpture, but work first. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Always finish work first. New one. Damn, nice one, Glass. That's awesome. Out of interest, Glass, if you don't mind me asking, where do you advertise? Yes, prepare dinner. If Kev can't eat his fine tender meat, he'll just have to settle for your fine tender meat. Sigh. Sigh, mate. Is that really something you want to think about? All I'm saying. But yes, Glass. Like I said, if you don't mind me asking, where do you advertise your commissions? Primarily, anyway. You dirty-minded degenerate. Mate, Sai, and there's an ale there. Sai, you're calling us the dirty-minded ones? Breath. Mate, breath. As on Facebook and Twitter. Oh, wow. That's surprising. Shit, does this mean I have to use Facebook? Alright, though, that's good to know. And thank you, by the way. Thank you for saying. Right, yeah, I need to get that sorted then. I've been procrastinating redoing my Facebook in a long time now. I guess Instagram may be a good one. Actually, no, fuck Instagram. You need a app for that, and I can't be asked for phone apps. I am a hypocrite, yes, but I'm an honest hypocrite. Ayol, should I say that voice chat phrase? Ayol. You pay $30 a month for adverts on my page on Facebook. Wow. Really? That's... For that kind of return, that's brilliant. Shit, I may have to look into that. Yeah, Glass, thank you for telling me. For a 3D model, how much would it cost? I've not opened yet. I'm not doing commissions yet. But the current pricing I have for something like I'm doing right now... Actually, let me check. For what I'm doing right now, let's say that I was charging for this. Right now, it would cost... Let me check. I spent 3.5 hours on this. It would cost. 3.5 hours. One sec. It's just round up. One second rounding up. Let's say it's 4 hours. Plus 60. Wow, I just fathomed. Let's pretend it's 4 hours plus the initial deposits. So right now, what I'm doing right now would cost £120. This here would be 120. Assuming that the remaining half an hour I colour in. I just realised 10 million points. I need to remesh and substance that detail, but good enough that you can probably keep it down to 200. Oh yeah, yeah, Digimel, you're completely right about that. I'm not rigging or anything like that. I don't have Substance Painter yet. I will. But I don't have those things yet, so I'm kind of just sticking to the high poly stuff for now. I will be looking into retopology, I will be looking into Blender, learning all that, and when I do, I will then look into actually having optimized sculpts that I can use in Substance Painter and so forth. But you are right, this is way too high poly at the moment. way too high. And welcome back, Pedro. Welcome back. Right, yes. What I do actually want to do is... I hate the goddamn character. Oh, actually, I remember something I need. Is that where to change it? I don't know, actually, Maro. I haven't looked into it, to be honest. I kind of just got on with the camera, so I'm not sure if there is a way or not to change it. Oh, that's wrong. One thing I want to do, actually... That's the wrong tool entirely. Is create like little crinkles in the frill. Would be a good one for that. Probably that one, right? Yes, that'd be good for it. Make that a little bit more intense. There you go. Let's start from up here then, shall we? Get rid of that one, that one, that one, that one. Don't need it. Okay, it's good enough. When it comes to social media, I don't use it much. Instagram, for example, is shit. I just see girls in my class just scrolling through people's stories and it's just boring. Yeah, so I know that Instagram can actually be quite good in terms of like getting yourself out there. So for me as a YouTuber or streamer, it'd actually be worthwhile me getting into it. The reason I don't use Instagram is because, well, people don't know what I look like, therefore I can't take photos. And Instagram, from what I understand, is primarily a mobile phone thing. There is a desktop version of it, but you need to like register and all that bollocks, and I'm very paranoid of internet security, so I don't. So all that kind of bollocks. But yeah, it's definitely one of the leading websites right now to like promote yourself. Facebook as well, especially if you do what Glass does and pay for ads or pay for exposure. That's very good. I know Doom did the same thing, actually. Doom also paid for exposure and got a massive results. But at the same time, though, I really, really hate social media. But yeah, feels bad, man. Feels bad. I've tried Amino. No, actually, no. I haven't. I've seen a couple of people use it, though. Is it big? I know it's a very superficial thing to ask for, but I'm not going to bother unless it's big. Okay, that looks significantly more interesting. I'd say so. Alright, I may have to look into it then. Thank you. Yeah, I forgot about Amino. I definitely need to look into that. I use Amino. Ah, I know Empiric does as well. I hate social media too. I just use it to advertise. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. But hey, it clearly works. I was recommended to use a fairy Amino to advertise my commission, and I'm yet to do that. Fair play, fair play. Yeah, I'm definitely going to check those things out then. Because right now, I've only put it on Deviant Arts that I'm even beginning commissions, let alone actually doing it. Obviously Discord, obviously that too. I will make a video on YouTube for it, since that's where the majority of my fan base is. But other than that though, I didn't really think much about it. So I should start exploring these different avenues then. I heard there were a lot of people that joined that particular one. Oh, fair enough. Fair enough. As long as it works, it works. As long as it's, you know, not an absolutely horrible website. Okay, I think I'm pretty satisfied with this for now then. I would have two colours on stream, but Kev will be here any moment now, and I do want to get up and have a stretch. So I'm probably better off just calling it quits for now. But is Mind Wolf still here? Hopefully she is. Yeah, she is, cool. So Mind Wolf, that's your sculpt so far then. I am so not looking forward to the damn tattoos. The war paint will be fine to do, but goddamn, the tattoos on her horns, that's going to be a nightmare. But I'm really, really liking how this is coming out so far. I really am. Definitely one of my favourites. Let's go see what it'll look like if it's rendered. Let's just zoom in a little bit first. There you go. Oh, my back. I need to... Oh, excuse me. You know what I think makes the model look neater? Smoothing our lips a little bit. I actually made the lips harsh and thin on purpose. Oh, look at that. Look at the shadows. Love it. But yeah, so I actually made the lips sharp on purpose, but I might look into that though, actually, Snazzy. If anything, I need to define the gums. That's something I do need to do. I see a 26th view account, and I wish I had that for my streams class. Mate, come join Twitch. On 101st of Amino, or maybe actually, I'm in a mania, you can make an anime for your YouTube channel and make a wiki on there just about the Jowie. That's pretty cool, actually. And Santa Sonic, you're welcome, dude. I'm really glad. I'm glad that you enjoyed it. Twitch never worked for you. Oh. Oh. That kind of blows. Don't mind me as I just look at different materials here. That's pretty cool, actually. What else? Let's check out, say... Damn, let's check out that one. Now that's pretty awesome looking. Twitch stream just refused to cooperate with me. That's really odd. Has experience as a Wikia admin. Oh yeah. I have a little bit of experience with that. Not great though. How does that one look? Damn, that looks awesome. Look at that. I enjoy looking at different materials far more than I should. You enjoy the golden material. Ah, yes. But yeah, like I said, I enjoy looking at these far more than I should. I don't know why. It's just awesome seeing all the different materials and options. I think I have a similar gold material, actually. I can't find it anymore. But what about this one? Many people don't use Twitch, and Twitch is bad at promoting content, so hard to grow a fan base based on Twitch alone. I suppose, yeah, you do have a bit of a point there, actually. You do have a point there. Yeah, I'm just being a bit obsessed with that one, so... Let's just shove on, let me see. This for now, make it look all chalky, and then we'll call it a night. Give the edges of the lips a softer, more rounded look. I think the harsher edges give them the modern charm. The sharpness of the edges of the lips was just, I don't know, it looks weird to me. That's fair. I do get what you're saying. I will look into that, dude. I definitely will. Like, as always, I appreciate the feedback. If it looks a bit odd, then I will try and make it just a little bit not odd. How'd you set the camera to be the model head on? Mara, as you're rotating around, hold shift, it'll snap. Like that. And then opt to, change the actual position, but shifts like set to different things. Oh god. As you can see, this is a little bit laggy now, isn't it? Certainly is very... You already painted your sculpt, so I can't test your materials. Yeah, it can look a little bit awkward and laggy. How does that look? Awesome. Right then. I'm gonna stop now before I get carried away. Right, guys. It's been an absolute pleasure. For the new people, I have a Discord server. You're more than welcome to come and join. Twitter, of course, as well. Kev just come home, so now I really do have to stop. And what was I gonna say? I will stream tomorrow. I don't know what yet, but I will be streaming something tomorrow, whether it's drawing or gaming or whatever. We'll figure it out. Bloody no, I just do it. I just wing it. And as always, thank you for a wonderful time. Thank you for the help and for the advice. And I will catch you all guys on Discord, or I'll see you tomorrow. I punched the mic. I'm very sorry. Bye.